pretty sure Aurora and Yohedva were still getting it on. Which is why I have them in this room where you can't see. And
Thank you for giving us
I got a switch.
Yep.
Brain dead.
And Thorhilda
unspeakable things to each other.
Thorhilda, she's kinda like waiting outside. She doesn't look too happy about being kicked out of her room. And
to be fair, she wasn't really given a room.
Yeah, that's true. I'm gonna say the Sheik, he's off in his own room somewhere now. In a nicer part of the inn. Julius, he's still back here. He's reading. He hasn't really left the inn much today other than to go to the Botanica.
To the temple?
No, he was going to go to the temple tomorrow, I believe, with you guys. And Thraka, she's still here doing slave stuff. But I don't remember if at this point if Kona was asleep or not still. So I'll leave that up to him.
I'm about to wake up.
Okay. Yeah, slave stuff. Like, you know, scrubbing floors, cleaning, getting beat.
Is Casey here?
Yeah, he's here.
Casey?
Yep,
oh, wait.
Being racially discriminated against.
Yeah, yeah. Yeah, he's here.
Okay. Hey, Casey, fuck you.
Okay, elf
poor guy.
And so you're all I'm gonna say the inn at this point is getting rather busy. There's more people in here just kinda drinking around. You can see Julius, he's reading his scriptures, but he keeps looking. You can tell he keeps looking up at Thraka, like he's interested in her, but she's very repulsed by him.
No.
There's gonna be no yeeting of Chase.
Yeah, no. Alright. So you guys can now do what you will.
Is Aurora carrying me like a bride into the inn?
No, right now Aurora.
I mean, not Aurora,
Agalus?
Agalus, yeah.
Yeah, I'll leave that up to her.
Miss Agalus?
Yeah,
I guess. Last time I remember, I put him over in the.
You did.
Oh, that's loud. Holy shit.
Yeah.
It's not that loud.
I had it turned way up.
Yeah, Mooka's jamming out.
I was listening to sea shanties.
Yep, and now you are again.
Hell yeah. But yeah. Okay, so
I went and put him over in the room next to.
Okay. Are you going to put him in the room your dad was in?
Yeah, that was the room he was in.
Okay, so
I'm gonna wake up as we're walking into the inn though.
Okay.
Slowly.
I probably would have showed Thorhilda to her room before, you know, like I wouldn't just leave her out in the hall and not to that much of a mess.
Thorhilda, she did not want any part of what you two were doing.
Yeah, but that would have like been like, oh, well, there's a room next to us, and
okay. And
been like, you can stay in here.
All right, so Thorhilda has made her way off into this room then, and she is just kind of sulking in the corner.
Because that's where she's spotted from.
Yeah, yeah. She's having conflicted feelings that she's kind of getting sweet on a little halfling like Domri. She's not really sure about what to make of it. Okay.
To be fair, he's not that short.
Yeah.
Well, no, but to her she is. Or to her he is. She's
Rizzy's
a
really
tall.
Short one.
Yeah.
He's the tallest person.
Yeah, but, you know. Okay. So I'm gonna say it is getting late, so if you guys want to do anything before you have to go to sleep, now's the time. Or if you just want to wake up and do stuff.
Yeah, I'm waking up. I
want to
get a drink.
Gonna go ahead and go to sleep.
I forgot to write down that chick's name. What was her name again?
Which chick?
The slave orc or whatever they're called. I can't remember what the race is called.
Oh, the slave, the bartender slave, Thraka.
Thraka. That's her name.
I'm going to hit up, I guess Thraka.
Okay.
Same.
And I'm gonna be like, hey, could we get like a wake up call for like maybe 5-ish in the morning?
Well, I look like a slave.
All right, boss. Anything you say.
I'm certainly not your boss, but okay. Thank you.
Yeah, she grabs a sponge out of a soapy bucket and she just keeps going at the floors.
Oh, that's right.
I guess light on the sponge. No, I don't. it's a glow sponge. What kind of Minecraft, motherfucker?
That just means it works better.
Hey.
Yeah.
You see that priest over there?
Yes.
Can you get him to leave me alone? He's kind of making weird faces at me. I don't really like it.
I definitely can do that. I don't like him.
I mean, what kind of man does he think he is? He goes and changes his name, acts like some kind of human. Disgusts me.
His name. Oh.
Let me tell you, nobody in Bastion has a name like Julius. I bet his name's like Irk or Grok or something silly like that.
Oh, I'm just gonna go list off a bunch of names and figure it out.
God damn it, did Cat just DC?
And just.
Yeah. Did Cat DC? Probably, but that's okay because he's asleep.
I need him for this though.
Okay.
Alright, well, I guess since that can't happen, I'm gonna go over and say, hey, Grom, Throck,
Jorg. Hello, Mr. Heathen.
What's your actual name, sir?
Oh, my name is Julius Tolisk Cyril.
No, it's not.
Excuse me?
Mm-hmm.
No, that's your given name by the church. What's your name?
I see what you mean. Well, I'm afraid that Julius is the only name I ever knew. I never knew my real parents.
Can I insight check?
Yes, you can.
Alright, what is my insight? That's 5. Wow, 8 total?
8. You have no insight on this information.
Oh, no, that was just to see if he was lying or not.
Oh, to see if he's lying? He's not lying.
You find his birth certificate.
Yeah.
It's strapped to his back with a sign that says, kick me.
Yeah, exactly.
Said he was born in some place called Kenya?
Yeah. that's good.
It's like, all right. I'm not sure if I believe you, Mr. Julius Castro.
Well, when I was a child, I was bought into slavery by the Hierophant in Amalka.
The Hierophant.
He raised me from a young age. He taught me how to live as a civilized man, not a barbarian like the rest of my people.
Civilized is a strong word for what the church does, but, you know. Alright. Well, I guess that's a story. If you ever happen to find your name, I would like to appreciate it. Well, yep, I would like to appreciate it. Those are words. I didn't say that in character.
Well, I appreciate the sentiment, Mr. Heathen, but I don't think a name matters much, because all of us are equal in the eyes of the Lord.
You'd be surprised what magic's going to happen because of a name. Alright, I walk away, just, like, I give him a wink saying that to creep him out.
And as you walk away, you notice he is staring at Thraka's butt as she's bent over scrubbing the floor.
And I turn around. Oh, and by the way, stop that or I will stab you in the penis.
Stop what?
Stop looking at Thraka.
He turns bright red and he just, like, puts his face right back in his book.
A slave like you should have nothing to, fucking words. I lost everything. Oh, no.
His book is just pictures and more butts.
Oh, my God.
A slave like you should have nothing to do with a woman like her. You're a slave to the Lord.
Yes. Indeed, of course. I would never.
The heels are so fucking
And also, she's better than you. I leave.
Okay.
DPS could be better.
Yeah.
DPS is on fire.
That definitely could be better.
If I happen to catch a Thraka's blaze, wow, nope. The other word, oh my god, gaze.
I say we RP it without Cat.
I will wink at her.
Okay, we can RP it without Cat.
Wow, and our fucking...
Are we told about Honor Stone though?
Unless Bunny wants to take over Cat's character.
Ooh!
You know what, our fucking team.
Cat was asking for a,
imagine C9-ing. Two tanks, a DPS, and a healer.
No, Bunny would be a bunny. But anyway, yeah. That kind of sucks, because Agalis was probably literally supposed to have, like, one of the most defining parts of her character arc pretty...
I don't need Agalis to talk, but I do need her for this.
Oh, no!
Okay, that's fine, that's fine.
You know, I don't you need know what's out. Up. You know
Fuck!
Alright.
I'm gonna go over to everyone except Rizzy and ask him if they want a drink.
Okay.
Hell yeah.
Hell yeah. Okay, that's one from Domri. Do you want a drink, Valinor?
If they have something honeyed, perhaps, but if not.
Okay. Does anyone else want a drink? Can't remember everybody's name.
Some guy who is at the bar, some old man. He's like, I want
No. I meant in our group. Who the fuck are you? Go away. I don't know you.
Get out of here.
Sorry.
Fucking dirty old man.
Man leaves the bar. Just.
Yeah. Yeah, he walks out. His
fuck
head
is you.
Does he look really sad? Does he look really sad?
He looks so defeated.
Come back. Come back.
All right.
This old man walks. He's like, yes, sir.
What do you want?
I want the love I never
had.
A drink.
All right, I'm here to fix your life.
Wine would be nice.
Okay, a wine. How about you, bananas? This dude's still fucking eating.
I like to imagine
a beer.
Yeah, yeah.
Okay. A fine stout.
Okay.
Hey, my buddy wants a beer.
Okay, I'm gonna go back to the room.
Okay,
and I'm
so
going...
you open the door, and you can see Thorhilda just kind of like sitting cross-legged in the corner, just looking kind of glum.
Oh, she's
and
awake.
She's awake, and Agalus is just out.
Fuck. Okay. Well, then I'm gonna back out into the hallway, and I'm gonna stealth into the room.
Okay.
You enter the room, leave, and stealth back in.
Yeah. Yep. I got 22 for stealth.
Oh, nice. You stealth greatly.
Okay. And then from what I remember, Gallus has the money she got a bunch of the money we were collecting.
That is true, I believe.
Because I have no money, so I can't buy any drinks.
True. Okay.
So I'm gonna pickpocket Gallus.
Yeah, so I'm going to ask, how much of it do you steal, like a percentage, or just
yeah, half of it.
Okay, you steal half of her money?
Well, our money.
Okay.
Yeah, okay.
So I'm going to ask you to roll, sleight of hand.
My sleight of hand bonus. Hell yeah. 18.
Nice. Okay, you take half the money.
I don't remember how much money she had though.
Neither do I. I'll get it from Kat later. But you have half of an indeterminate of some money.
Okay, I have half of $1 million. Cool.
Ooh. No, that's what I have.
And I'm gonna go up to Thraka and ask for the drinks. And I'll buy her a drink too.
Sorry, sir. I'm not allowed to drink on the job. And well. Being a slave, I'm always on the job.
Are you allowed to disobey customers?
Yeah, really. I order you a drink.
Good point. Well, thanks, sir.
Yep,
and she walks off behind the counter.
Oh, wait. I go over to her again.
Yeah.
The beer that you give to the weird fuzzy short guy, you can spit in that one if you want to.
Ah, good. Okay. I saw him checking out my ass like the other guy.
Sounds like him.
I'll look forward to this.
Okay. Yep, thank you.
Yeah. All right. So she comes back with
We're all just standing in the middle of the room.
Yeah, you are.
Yeah. Who needs a table?
Yeah.
She comes back with a tray full of like a small ceramic cups, and she just kind of hands everything out. And then she goes and she gives a cup to the sad old man.
All right, I forgot about him.
Yeah, as she leaves, the old man goes to and pats her on the ass. And she goes to.
Did he just do that?
Yeah, he just did that.
All right, I take his drink.
Oh, okay. And she sees you take his drink, and she laughs as she walks back to work.
Valinor's a wine guy, right?
Honeyed wine, preferably.
Oh shit! Right. God damn it! I didn't even ask you about that.
It's fine.
It was ambrosia.
Ambrosia.
Mm.
Yeah.
Well then, I drink the wine.
Don't question where I get my nectar. This divine.
Yeah.
My favorite drink is the tears of slavers.
Oh, that's like 85% alcohol.
Yeah, and blood, obviously.
Slavers drink a lot.
You're a vampire.
Oh yeah.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, that is true. they were quite sauced, and I mean, you guys don't want to know this, that kind of stuff Nasher was drinking.
Well,
the gal is drinking.
All they all were rolling.
Yeah, yeah, that's true. She almost died because of that, actually. So, okay, so Aurora, are you still making love to this prostitute?
First of all, she's not a prostitute. She is a knight companion.
Okay.
Second of all, no. I mean, okay. You know, after like a while, you know.
Yeah, I don't know how long an Isham would take to do that kind of stuff.
About as much as a normal. Like,
okay.
If anyone knew, wouldn't it be you, Luke?
Yeah, depends on how much
it would be Bora. It would be Bora. Bora is in charge of all that kind of stuff for Isham.
Well, yeah.
Okay.
So what's
really
the answer? What's the answer?
Special about
that. Yeah.
Just so I know,
length.
Research.
So 4 yeah. minutes, 4 hours.
Normal human time, I guess. That can,
yep,
that
yeah.
can vary.
4 hours. Yep.
Yeah, yeah.
Okay, so at this point now, Yohedva, she is sitting on the foot of a bed, and she has a long pipe. Like one of those lady pipes, and she's just kind of like blowing off.
A cigarette stick?
Yeah, kind of like that, but it's like there is like a kind of pipe like that.
101 Dalmatians? Oh, okay.
Yes, exactly. Yeah, yeah.
All right.
Well, I'm going to like get out of bed and like start to get dressed. And like, oh, I'm going to go to downstairs and get some drinks. Do you want to come?
Oh no, that's all right. I'm not into that much into alcohol. No, besides, I've drank enough fluids to suit me for the night.
Okay.
Well, that answers one question.
Make sure you stay hydrated.
She's a squirter.
Yep.
And a swallow.
I'm gonna go to the. Wait, no, I'm going to check up on this one first, and then I'm just gonna be like, "How are you doing in the corner?"
Oh, I'm all right, little hornling. Just not sure what I should do right now.
Well, I know what you should do. You should come down with me and to the bar and get some drinks with some folks. Cheer up your spirits.
No, that's alright. I don't really like being around the manlings very much. They look at me like I'm some kind of freak.
Oh, no, I get that. But alcohol really helps with that.
Well, if there is one thing I can do, it's murder people. And the other thing...
Can I roll to, like, persuade her?
You already have persuaded her with the promise of alcohol.
Alright, so let's go!
Alright. So you guys go down here, and,
I mean, I do see them, but I'm gonna go to, like, the alcohol counter first.
Yeah.
The alcohol counter.
Garen. Yeah, Garen.
Otherwise known
just
as the bar.
Is. Yeah.
The bar. He sees her, and he's like, what was his voice? Oh my god, what the hell is that beast doing up here?
You don't have a basement, so it's like, you know.
And whatever.
Anyway, we would like some drinks.
Fine, but that thing has to pay extra.
And I whisper in Thorhilde's ear, hey, I can't cover you, don't worry about it. What
all right. Maid, lots of maid.
I'll take
I ain't no
two
milk
of
drink.
Your largest things of mead.
Mead, savages. All right. So he brings back two steins of mead, and Thorhilde takes it, and she just she gulps it down in one big go, and she just slams it on the counter.
And say okay, and then I give her the other one.
And she does that too, slams it on the counter.
Wow, how do you feel?
I feel fine.
All right, I'll have two more of those.
He brings them back, and he keeps doing that, and Thorhilde just keeps chugging them.
I'm just going to keep slapping buying them.
Am I the only one who didn't get money this campaign? What the fuck?
I don't think she
I have
money.
No idea how.
I think she's yeah.
I mean, how much does it cost? I have money.
Maybe a couple
okay.
copies.
I have a chart here. One drink is.
They just left you money on that cross?
Yeah.
Just in case you get out of here.
No.
Yeah.
I only picked it up recently from the dead slave who dead slaver who like
I got five Aurelius from all the slaves I made.
No, as a rule of thumb, I will say every drink is 2 Follis, so that's cheap.
Okay.
Like 2 copper.
So 5 Aurelius could buy 25 beers.
Yes.
Okay.
Hell yeah.
And get smashed.
I used all my Aurelians buying that post-workout after I was working out with Chattius.
I gave mine away to somebody. I don't know who
you got the Atlas tonic.
Yeah.
Did you drink that yet? I forget.
I drank it like right after worked out.
Is there anything that's like Irish cream, like Dacian cream, or?
Not in this bar, but they would cream. Have. They would
I mean,
have
actually, there is some Dacian
drinks.
Cream in this bar.
Mm-hmm. Well, I mean, it has to be.
You just gotta look.
Alcoholic.
It will be
a couple,
like,
more, yeah, a couple
hours.
More drinks. Give me a couple more drinks.
That's too much time to wait.
All right, fine.
Yeah.
Fine, 1 hour
I'm
max.
I'm just going to get one of her meats.
3 hours plus 4 minutes to 4 hours, somewhere in there.
Okay, so after a while, he's like, a big pile of empty flagons just kind of surrounds Thorhilda, and he's like, "I'm sorry, but I have dumped 50 drinks into this mutant creature's belly. I'm not doing any more until you pay me."
All right, well, how much does it cost again?
That would be 10 Aurelius, or for just beers, right?
Yes. Yeah, it would be 10.
All right, well, I pull out
which is
one,
10 silver.
I pull out one solid die, and I put it on the thing. And
Oh my. Wow, You mutants really are generous, aren't you?
Well, it's one solid die. You know, you said it was 10 Aurelius, which is
Aurelius
one
is...
solid die.
Yes. Yes. Okay.
So, I mean, that is perfect.
All right. Why, thank you. I'm glad I'm making money. And so he goes off into the bar as you guys continue to get sloshed. And I am honestly kind of just waiting for.
I only bought one
to
round.
Because
I don't know how much money I have.
You bought one round. That was 1, 2, 3, 4.
I'm just saying.
5.
I don't know how sloshed I'm getting because I only bought one round.
Not very. Yeah, that's true. Good point. I kind of meant just Bora and Thorhilda.
I'd buy more if
you
I knew how much money I had.
Yeah. Good point. So Valinor, do you want to bring up your plans for tomorrow with the party?
Kind of, but I would need to acquire the Aurora.
Okay. Well, she is currently drinking
counter.
At a bar with a giant woman.
I use message.
Okay.
And I'll just whisper in a weird voice. It's like, Hey Aurora.
Listen,
hey, listen.
Yeah.
Nope. Hey, Aurora, come here.
Leslie, is it you?
Yeah.
I'm going to look around and like, well, no, I haven't heard that voice in my head before.
It's me.
Yeah, it's
a
new one.
It's your inner weenus.
What does that even mean?
Come over to the group.
It's your inner elbow.
I would use message as many times as it took.
Okay. Yeah, you can do that unlimited, you know.
We need to go over to the other mandling, to the mandlings that we know. I'm going to see that to Thorhild.
Yeah, okay.
Hey, what do we call you guys if we're mandlings?
I hope.
You could call them all sorts of racist things.
Yeah,
you
I'm going
to
start
of.
Doing that if you keep calling me a mandling.
Also, I would have loved so much if, like, Thor girl was perfectly fine sitting, but she just gets up and falls over immediately.
Oh, that is a good,
just like 50 beers.
You know what?
Just like boom.
Okay, so she proudly stands up triumphantly. She smashes her last flagon onto the counter. She walks over and then she just falls right on her face.
Nice. Okay.
I'm going to try to like help her up and like have her like lean on me as we like.
All right, I'm going to ask you to roll a strength check.
Oh, and my tail is still hidden, so do I get disadvantage?
Yes, you do.
Oh, no.
They already know you're mutant.
Yeah, but they don't know that she's like a super mutant with a tail.
You know, clothes 15, fall off when you're drunk, or when you're 15, drunk sometimes. Okay, maybe your tail popped out. Oh, okay.
So you are slowly dragging this, this mass of muscle behind you. You are, she's moving, but barely. And as you pull her, she just lets out a huge belch.
And I just start laughing, like...
Valinor is just like... Oh, God. Oh, no. Friends, I don't mean to alarm you, but something horrible has occurred over there. Oh, no, here it comes.
And I'm going to get to the table, and I'm just going to, like... Just, like, sit down with Thorhildren. I'm going to wave at them, like, come over here. Stop standing in the middle of the room.
Yeah.
Why don't you come over here? You look totally sober and fine.
Yeah.
It's so very far away.
Yeah. It's less effort for you to come here than for all of us to go there.
And I just glare at you.
I could use this.
I walk over.
Yeah, I just sit down. Is this,
I'm going to sit Thorhildren in the chair.
Is she passed out? Like, she's out?
Yeah, she's out. She's all out. Right.
I'm gonna go over to Thraka and ask for a glass of warm water.
Alright.
Warm water.
Okay. And some shaving cream.
Shaving cream? What's shaving cream?
No, people don't shave their fucking beards here, Mook.
I
lather. Something to lather.
Alright, I'll get some butter.
Some dacian cream, please.
Butter.
Butter doesn't lather.
Taste and cream, better drop thy pants, sir.
You know what? Yeah,
fine, I'll make it myself.
people shave with a product called Dacian cream.
Oh, nice.
Don't ask what it's made out of.
It's made of that and flour, and they just kind of whip it.
Is it even a Dacian product?
It is bright blue.
Dacians, or is it just they just named it because it was blue?
Nobody knows, other than the people who make it. It's a closely guarded secret. Okay.
That's so, blue,
so
too?
She puts you down on the on the counter.
It's like a sky blue.
Yeah, yeah.
I nut in Robin's egg.
Pretty much, yeah. But only when I'm told to.
Commander's like, I need more cream, sir. Sir, I need more cream. Fucking...
Okay.
Bitch.
So all of you guys, I guess, are gathered around this table. Except Degallus, who is asleep still.
Did I get the warm water yet?
Yes, you did.
Okay.
Warm water.
I'm going to also, right as you walk back, can you also get us two waters, please?
You folks are are demanding.
Can her whole hand fit
Thank
in this
you kindly,
cup or no?
Beautiful.
It could not. Maybe
how many
fingers?
Fingers.
I'm going to say, like, three.
All right, I'm going to try and put three of her fingers in the warm cup.
Okay.
Oh, no. Going to make Thraka clean up that? That's 50 mugs of juice.
No. It's just a cup of warm water, like a normal.
No. I know what you're doing. Valinor knows. He's sitting around the block.
Yeah. Okay. So she brings more water.
I'm going to, like, try to get Thorhild to, like, drink some water.
Oh, shit.
Well. She is passed out.
I'm going to maybe just put a little bit of water in her mouth and, like, do that thing where you, like, tilt her head back and then rub her. Because I don't want her to fucking die from alcohol.
You can...
That's a medicine check right there.
Yeah. You should probably roll a medicine.
And your drink. And your drink, yep.
And your drink. Your drink better roll.
Yep.
Let us see. I got 21.
Oh, nice. Okay, so you know that you would have to make sure that she doesn't sleep on her back, and that you need to make sure that she gets enough electrolytes. But other than that, she will probably be fine.
All right.
You sense that this girl has this is not her first rodeo.
I just want to make sure that she wakes up tomorrow.
Yep.
While she's babysitting her, can I put the Dacian cream in her other hand? Just a big glob of it.
Yes, you can.
Cool.
As you do that, I'm actually going to ask you to do a acrobatics check.
Yeah, easy. I was in the circus. Five, 16.
16. Okay. So as you do it, her fist like reflexively just comes barreling towards you, but you dodge out of the way then.
Which fist? The cream fist or the water fist?
The cream fist.
Okay. Is the cream still intact in her hand or?
Her fist is currently covered in Dacian cream.
But like, is it a pile of it or is it just like spread all over the place now?
It's kind of a smeared globule.
Okay, that's the worst. That's the worst.
Globule. Yeah. Okay.
I'm gonna ask everybody at the table if they have a feather. Anybody got a feather?
So what are you doing?
Nope. Oh my god, you guys are supposed to be discussing your plans, but you're just fucking with a drunk girl.
First, I have a feather. Because I killed the chicken earlier today.
Oh, that's right. That's right.
You did.
Hell yeah.
Can I have it?
That did indeed eat that whole chicken and barked out the feather.
Could I have that feather, please?
Wait. What do you need it for?
I travel. I collect feathers from all the different countries.
It's all right.
Okay.
Or it's
and then
fine.
I give it
yeah.
to her.
Yeah.
Give it to Kona.
Okay. And I just sit there with my feather now.
Okay.
I'm gonna go back to not paying attention.
Okay.
Sort of like, kind of like.
Spaced.
Kind of spaced, doing my best to take care of Thorhild, but honestly, I'm.
Oh, wait, am I still covered in shit?
I am gonna say covered is a strong word, but you know, you have not changed. At least you have not told me you have changed. So you are still kind of stinky.
What is that smell?
That's you. That's why I'm sitting on this side of the table.
Yeah.
Tommy's right fucking next to me, though.
Smells like home.
I'll be right back.
Oh, no.
Okay.
I'm going to ask Throcko if there's a sink or something around.
There's a bucket, trough out back that's full of water.
I go to the trough.
Okay. Okay, there you go. You are cleansing yourself in a tub of horse backwash.
Yeah.
Mm. Oh, I'm suddenly going to remember why I'm here. Scoop. Oh, guys, I just had this weirdest thing. There's some sort of like thing that was talking in my brain that wasn't God. It was strange.
Oh, what was it? What did it call itself?
I don't remember. But it told me to come and speak to you, so.
Oh. That sounds a lot like a weenus.
That is what they called me! How did you know? It's because you're the magical.
No.
Wait, you got 21 medicine and you know what a weenus is?
Yeah. Maybe Ishim don't have weeni.
Maybe not.
Yeah, that's a good point. That's a good point.
They don't have elbows, they just have tube arms.
Oh my god.
You would think I would know about it because I am a trained physician. But, you know, I guess I missed that.
You skipped
day.
Elbow day.
Yeah, true.
Skip elbow day.
Yeah. Okay.
So oh god, what's. Oh, okay.
Mook, just tell me when I'm done washing.
You were done washing, like, about now.
Oh, okay. Then I make my way back in.
Yeah, you can come back. All of you now are going to discuss what Valinor has learned and what you guys are going to do tomorrow and how you're going to go about it.
Right. I'm hand gesturing a lot for no reason. In character.
Tomorrow. Yeah.
Okay. Yes. So tomorrow at 7 a.m., hand gestures involved.
Yes.
The Zanara is landing. We need to board that and preferably at least save the one I need to get off of there because she's extraordinarily important. And I think Aurora wants to murder that senator. So do I.
Wait, we're doing this at 7 a.m.?
Right.
I mean,
so before the fighting tournament.
The fighting tournament is the day after tomorrow.
Oh, it's a day after tomorrow.
We just have to not really be seen.
Easy.
Because then it's hard to possibly participate.
I've never failed a stealth check.
So, I have a disguise persona of a whiny-ass lower nobleman that I can use. Aurora was saying that Agalas could be my wife, which is weird. I've never thought about having a wife before. Aurora, you tell the rest. I believe in you.
I came up with this plan. Alright, so what it is that we can pose as people and sneak into the ship and then kill him while he's alone.
Why are we killing this guy again? I was sleeping.
Oh, because he's a dirty, filthy slaver boy.
Oh, the usual reason, okay.
Oh yeah, just the usual reason. But also, if we kill him, it might cause a lot of political, you know, disturbance, which would be pretty funny. So that is why. So,
okay, so slavers in the lulls. Cool.
Kona, if you recall, the first when you guys earlier this morning, when you first got to the city, and traffic and the airships was held up by that
yeah,
that
I remember
drunk
the ship.
Guy.
Yep.
You remember him? Okay.
Yeah, I remember the ship. Okay. I just didn't know why we were going on the ship.
Yeah, no, I know. I just wanted to know if you were aware that's what you were doing.
Out of character, I know.
Okay.
In character, I'm just like I was sleeping.
Okay.
So. Yeah, there's this senator, some sort of high political person, and I think it would be a pretty good idea to send a message of death to him.
I cast and, message.
Well, as long as he's a piece of shit.
No.
Definitely seems like a piece of shit.
Yeah, that goes.
Well, we'll confirm it when we get there, I guess.
And I sort
of it's...
Like,
been confirmed by
most
well,
of
I'll
the
confirm
reason
it for mother... myself you know.
Yeah most of the reason you originally it was originally wanted to get in there is because the voice the spirit that talks to Valinor told him to go in there and rescue somebody that was incredibly important.
I just usually don't go around killing random people, that's all.
Well, that part's
at least not anymore.
Slavers, and they're not people if they're slavers.
Well, they're people. They're just
shitty
people.
In the back, you hear Garen just sneeze. It's like, oh, is somebody talking about me?
I use message on Garen.
Okay.
And I say, nope, no one was.
Oh, well, thanks, Brain. I guess no one was talking about me.
What the fuck?
Does everyone else hear that part?
I'm not.
Who the fuck are you talking to?
Yeah, when you messaged
Garen, who are you talking? I know, no.
What?
No,
what?
You said that we heard Garen, right?
Yeah.
Do do we see you talking to, like, your hand or some shit?
Yeah, that's good.
Pretty
point.
Much, yeah. I, like, whisper in my hand. But, yeah.
He just looks very confused, like, wait, what?
I use message it again. Hey, Garen, I think you're getting a little sick. You should go to bed.
Oh, all right, Brain. I guess I'm going to bed.
Holy shit. Okay.
Fracka, make sure to keep the place together. I'm going to bed. This voice is really inconsistent because I can't remember what it's supposed to sound like.
Just kind of shitty managerial person.
Yeah.
Somebody who's very annoyed at their job.
Jewish,
too.
It was originally supposed to sound like... Yeah, it was originally supposed to sound kind of like a English, shitty English accent, but then it just kind of sounded kind of...
Oh, yeah. It definitely came off as...
Brooklyn-ish.
Yeah, Brooklyn
Whiny.
Jew.
Yeah. Unfortunate. Okay. So yeah, Garen has gone off to bed.
Nice.
Thraka, join the party.
It's
not like we're plotting anything over here.
She looks around, she's like, well, alright. She just
I'll help you clean later.
The table.
We'll help you.
I will. I don't know.
Yeah, noses.
So yeah.
Who's the last person
to
put their nose on or their finger on their nose?
Yeah. Probably Rizzy.
Probably Rizzy.
Wasn't me, that's for sure.
Looks like
no,
you're
it was not Bunny.
I was instant.
Yeah, right.
Thor Hilda's because she's like slumped over the table right now, just kind of like laying right on it.
She's laying on the table now.
She's like falling off her chair and just kind of like.
Can I see her face? Can you see her face?
Yes.
I'm gonna tickle her nose with the feather.
Okay. So I'm gonna say you need to do a sleight of hand check.
Oh jeez. Well, I want to do it overtly.
Overtly. Oh.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, so that we see.
Yeah. Everybody can
see
it.
Oh.
I just
want
to tickle
her
nose.
Ahead. Okay.
What are you doing?
So as you tickle her nose, she. Just kind of like, and she sneezes really loudly, and she gets up and she kind of falls onto the floor.
I'm going to try to help.
Hey, okay, good morning.
Probably take her back.
I'll kill all of you.
Wait, does she still have the shaving cream on her hand?
Yes, she does. Okay. And you have noticed, Kona, that she has soiled herself.
Got him.
All you bastard manlings and you stupid, handsome, friggin' halfling wouldn't even kick my ass. What kind of man can't even
kick her ass. Kick her ass.
Also, she's way too small.
I'm going to try to help her back to the place.
Okay.
I'm going to help you help her. I'll get one side.
Thank you, you're very kind.
Yes, I know, I'm going to help the other side.
Okay.
As I'm helping, I'm still reaching up to tickle her nose with a feather.
I would like to talk to Thraka.
Okay. So as these guys go do that, you guys, I guess, are still talking about your plan for tomorrow, and you are talking to Thraka now?
Yeah. Thraka Ali. God, what even fucking was that? Oh, that was a YouTube thing, ancient times.
You're old.
So, Thraka. Yeah. You're old, too. You're older.
Seasoned.
You're what? Seepin'?
Seasoned.
Seasoned.
Oh, okay. Yeah. He was left overnight in the fridge in a sealed bag with salt.
I've been
and
marinating, bitch.
You should roast. Yes. Hopefully you're not beer marinated, because that's always gross. It's never good. So, Thraka, I'm not sure how much you hear or see around here, but are there any interesting things happening in town besides the gang war?
Well, I know I'm not supposed to talk about this, but, you know, Garen's not here.
It's just us.
There's something weird going on in town. People are up and vanishing all over the place.
Yeah, we know about that one.
Especially slaves like me. People are whispering, they're saying, you know, it's no accident that it has something to do with the higher-ups.
That's almost certainly true. We're,
I don't know.
We're here trying to fix that.
I don't know what's going on, but I don't like it.
No, we met some slavers out in the desert who were sending slaves here that just totally disappeared.
Oh, I assume you mean the Nasher and those guys.
Yeah, we met Nasher.
Ah, good.
Temporarily.
He's kind of the reason why I'm here.
Oh, well, you'd be glad to know that he is very much not alive anymore.
Oh, good. Fuck that guy.
Let's not. He was a behemoth. He was wolfy.
Behemoths need love, too.
Yeah, you know, some people are furries.
Not that furry.
Oh, no.
Good furries.
Don't get shamed, boys.
She kind of shrugs it off, and she's like, I've heard rumors of shadowy figures stalking the night, too. People are scared that that's why people are disappearing. I don't know.
Ooh.
Kind of
okay,
like
that is
phantoms or something.
Phantoms. So, very, very hard to see. Like, actually invisible or just very stealthy? Do you know?
I don't know. I heard. All right. I heard they look like shadows moving through the night.
Dope.
That's good to know. Hopefully we're into those so we can track down where they're going. Interesting.
I don't know, if I were you guys, I wouldn't poke my nose where it doesn't belong. People in this city between the yellow gang and the green gang, whatever the heck the console's doing, tend to wind up dead.
Whoa. Interesting. I am. Me, Hyblast, the person. No brain. Me, no think. This is an issue.
Okay. I am going to say that Kona and Aurora are
No. What happened with her nose?
I don't know.
I've been tickling it the whole time the way back.
Yeah, and she keeps sneezing.
God damn it.
The fuck is wrong with this lady?
Yeah, does she have no reflexes? What's her hands doing?
I mean, she... She did try to punch you a few times. All right,
that's it. I grab the hand with the shaving cream and I smack it on her face.
What did you?
I am going. Okay,
the cream.
I'm going to say, dexterity saving throw.
Easy. Oh shit. That's saving throw would be an 8.
An 8, okay, so.
I know, I see you, just get over with it, come on.
She gets up, and she just kind of like falls on you, and then she just vomits all over you.
I just washed myself!
Covered from both ends.
God damn it.
And then she passes out on the floor, and she falls asleep. I'm gonna ask you, Aurora, to roll a strength check now.
Okay. With this is... Oh, okay, so that's, I got 16.
Okay, you can hoist her. You strain yourself. Because she is very large, but you hoist her up onto the bed, and the bed just kind of like it sinks under her weight, just kind of like it hits the ground.
And I'm going to like get her on their side, so like if she vomits, she doesn't choke and die and stuff.
Yeah, definitely.
All right, and then I just like brush my hands and then walk out the door, just like little.
Fair enough. Okay.
Well, I'm pissed. Mook, I'm gonna let you decide this. Am I a sympathy vomiter?
Oh,
do I vomit when I see somebody vomit?
Yeah, that's 100% what Kona would do.
No, I just vomit everywhere.
Okay.
But I do. I aim it at her, this bitch.
Okay. Okay. She is non-pulsed as she is fast asleep.
Yeah, get fucked. I'm gonna go wash myself again.
Okay.
In the shit water now.
Of the two rooms, you guys. They've both gotten trashed. One has been trashed by an insane man, and the other has been covered in sexual fluids and vomit.
What sleeping person doesn't smack their nose when they sleep? This chick is an idiot.
Yeah.
what happened to your Don?
Yohedva? Don't know currently. She has left somewhere.
Who?
All right, whatever.
Yohedva, the girl who likes a good sandwich.
Oh, okay.
Oh, yeah. Hey, Mukathin.
Yep.
I would like to point out that Thraka looks like a mixture of the buff wife from Full Metal Alchemist and Thrall's wife.
Oh, yeah, kinda.
Whose name is also Thraka.
Was it?
Are you serious? I have to look this up now, because I swear I came up with that name. I was just thinking, like, okay, what's a female orc name? Like,
no, it's Agra.
Okay,
there we go. That one.
There we go. Okay, good. I was, like, seriously freaked out for a second.
Like, Mook, you're just recreating everything. You got the Destiny Ball, you got Thrall's wife.
Hey, man.
Oh, I didn't notice this nice tavern picture. Oh, that's actually, like, perfect. Jesus.
Yeah, okay. So you guys, so we don't stay in the inn forever. You should probably get on with the Zanara plan.
Alright. So get back to the table and I'm gonna start explaining my... Here's the plan. So what happens is we pretend to be a nobleman and his retinue, and we're going to their thing tonight to get onto the ship, and I pretend to be a gift, and we go and manage to get the praetor alone by himself, because we want to finalize the paperwork, and then we all surprise him and kill him. Now, this is my plan. I am very drunk.
I like this.
I sort of like fall on the table a little bit, but we need to do some recon beforehand. So I was thinking tomorrow morning.
We don't really have time for recon.
Okay.
At least as far as we know.
All you really know is that it leaves at 7, because that's what the Upkaluna told you.
Mm-hmm.
Right.
Yeah. That's what I remember.
Am I done washing yet?
Yes, you are. Actually, Kona, I'm gonna say, as you're walking Jesus back, Christ. you walk past like one of the upper area. You were in a different part of the inn, and you walk past the upper floor as you come back, and you can there is a large door and it is open. It is like slightly opened in there over here, and you can see. You're in the inn.
Okay.
And you can see the sheik you were talking to earlier, and he is having a go at Yohedva.
Oh.
Thumbs up.
Yeah, can he see me?
He does, actually, and as he looks up and looks at you, and he gives you a big thumbs up.
Yeah. I'm not going to give him a thumbs up. I'm just going to give him, like, a head nod back, like, yep. Nice.
Okay. Fair enough, fair enough.
Nice. I'm not in a good mood for thumbs up. I just got puked on.
Yeah, yeah. Fair enough, fair enough.
All right. I'm going to make my way back to the table then.
Okay.
And I'll be like,
so all right. The roles I have in mind are, and I point to Valinor and say, you're going to be the fancy. And I point to Darmry and I'm going to say, you could be like a lawyer or something. You wouldn't handle the paperwork. And I point to Kona and Rizzi and I say, we need to have what is called, we need to have security guards. And I think you guys would be perfect.
You had to pair us together?
Yeah, of course. I've always known how you guys, sort of have an eye for each other, so I didn't want to split you up.
Wow.
And then I
you're very say, perceptive.
And the Agalus is Agalus would be the haughty nobleman's wife who's super mean and racist to everyone.
She fits that role perfectly.
Exactly, that is what I was thinking.
Yeah. All right. So at this point, Thraka is currently scrubbing Thorhilda's pee off the floor.
Did she ever drink that drink?
Yes, she did.
Okay, I'll grab a rag and help her because kind of my fault.
Good, wow.
Yeah, so, Valinor is kind of putting some work.
Do the crime.
Too,
do the time.
Yeah. So she is very grateful. She thanks you guys for the help.
Yeah, I'll put in like 45 minutes or something.
Yeah.
It probably doesn't take
I'm going to put in 46 minutes, whatever's just one more minute than Valinor.
I don't
think it would
it's
take.
It's not a competition.
No, it's a lot of pee.
Okay, fair enough. She is an 8'5" tall woman.
Yeah, who drank 50 beers.
Yes, that is also true.
Didn't go to the bathroom once.
Yeah.
Come on.
God, she's going to fucking explode.
Yeah, she already did all over my body.
No. Like her fucking. She needs a lot of salt. Her blood must be like, whoop. Okay.
Oh, that gives me an idea.
What? Okay. I'm going to ask you guys if I'm going to ask the party if the party wants to take a rest at all before.
Did I get a rest in my horse shit?
Yes, Kona is rested.
Oh, hell yeah.
That would have been a short rest. He
fell asleep.
Oh, was that a short rest? Okay.
Yeah, it was only a little bit.
Okay.
I choose same as Domri. Okay. Fair enough.
Yeah, I assumed going to this we'd have time for a long rest.
What are they choosing? Yeah, yeah, yeah. What are they choosing over here?
They are choosing...
Drinks?
Drinks? I don't know.
I don't know. What did Domri choose? What did he...
I'm getting like a, you know, like a dark ale.
Oh, is that what's happening? We were just getting more drinks?
I don't know.
If you guys want to be hungover for your quest tomorrow.
Well, I mean, we're at the bar. We might as well.
We're at the alcohol counter. Come on.
Yeah.
The alcohol counter.
This is not the alcohol counter. It's over there.
The alcohol counter comes to us.
Yeah.
Oh, that is a brilliant invention.
Yeah.
The portable alcohol counter.
It's like a grub.
The alcohol counter card. Mm-hmm.
Uber drinks.
Yeah, Uber drinks.
All right. Well, if we're going to have more drinks, I'll be right back.
Okay.
I'm going to go steal some more money from Agalus.
There you go.
Okay, fair enough.
This time half, so another quarter.
Okay. I'm going to say, actually, when you go into that room, you will notice Agalus is... She has broken out in, like, a cold sweat. She does not look well.
She doesn't look well?
Yep.
I poke her.
She looks... nothing. She is as out as a rock.
Hey, don't wake up if you want me to take the money. Does she wake up?
She does not. No, she does not wake up. She is easy. She is dead as a log.
All right. Amazing. Yep. Consent. I'm going to take some money.
What are you doing, bro? So
wait, we'd be doing
what the fuck are you doing here?
Oh my god, Rizzy. Rizzy yeah, has yes. followed you.
I did.
Yes, Aurora, I got a wake-up call for 5 a.m.
Oh, you're stealing money? Nice. Well, yes, let's get some money.
I'm not stealing.
Get oh, yeah. some stuff if we're going to
no,
do
it's not
this,
stealing,
okay?
We're just borrowing.
Yeah.
Our money, too.
Exactly. I mean...
I watch.
Yeah, I like the recon idea, but I really don't know if we have time.
Damn, yeah, every time you guys talk about like recon, I'm not there. God damn it.
Are any of the shops open at this time?
It's a city.
It is a big city of 200,000 people, so I would, yes, the shops are still open.
Okay, if cool. You know I'm going what to I go mean. Get some stuff, but I don't have to, like, go and do it. Can I just, like, give
oh,
you a list?
You know what?
Yeah, you can give the party a list.
Okay. Well, I'm going... Well,
or right, we give I'll her a list. She's the one leaving, right?
Yeah.
I'm going to tell Rizzy about the window. I'm going to be like, yo, dude, you should go check out this window I saw.
What window?
It's like out the door, outside a little bit.
I will, I didn't drill it in, but I'll just go like.
Yeah, yeah, show him where to
there
look.
There you go.
Or show me where to tell him to look.
And they're in this room.
It's that room that's overlapping with the hallway.
Yeah.
The buildings don't have to be symmetrical. It's up before.
Yeah.
It's a surrealist.
Yeah,
art
yeah.
Building.
I see. It's abstract. I can
this
see
makes,
it.
This makes sense.
I can feel it.
But sure.
No. Yeah. Yeah.
What just use your brain, Rizzy.
You see a door that is slightly creaked open.
Can I stealth?
Yes, you can.
I rolled a 2. A D20.
I don't know where any of my dice are.
D20. It's the B.
Yeah,
it's
just,
the B
just
one.
Roll D20.
My dice are all gone.
Who stole his dice again, dude?
Oh wait, I know
they're
where
behind
they are.
The screen.
Cat's not yeah. even here this time.
There you go.
Oh, hello.
Do they say hello back?
Hello.
Creepy.
The heck?
No. Yeah.
Who named my D20 Arrow Finder 9000?
I don't know.
Did you fucking get all your arrows back? It's bullshit.
So oh, wait, Jace, yeah. did you do that?
I was like, which was my 9th?
No, I didn't
D20?
Do it. That's a good
oh.
name.
I might have yeah. done that. That sounds like something I would have done.
Yeah.
I was like, which was my D20? And it's like, Arrow Finder 9000. Like, what?
Yeah.
14 plus. My stuff plus 5, 19.
Okay, you are hidden from sight.
God, okay, such
and
a pervert,
inside,
dude.
you can stick your head and you can see same thing Kona saw, which was the Sheik having a go at Yohedva while all his servants
wow.
just kind of stand around and watch.
That name, man's a 4-hour man.
Her name is Yohedva.
Yeah, you didn't notice that.
More,
yeah, that's her name.
More like Yohedbra.
Who's your head, again?
She was okay. If you remember when you guys went to the Rolling Cabbage, you guys
yes.
went to the Rolling Cabbage. There was two prostitutes there. One was Thorhilda, who killed the
yes.
the owner, and the other
yes.
was there was another girl who honestly didn't mind, and she was just kind of like
oh the one that the one that got with Bora.
Yeah, yeah, the one.
Oh, okay,
was...
I just can't remember her name.
Yeah.
Do I hear what they're saying?
They're not really saying anything.
It's just a quiet fuck.
There's a grr, grr.
Yeah, yeah, they're making... They're
bed
making,
squeaks.
Yeah, you know. The bed is quite squeaky.
Do they have springs?
Oh, wait,
do we have springs in this universe?
Yes. I'm going to say
oh,
yes.
Oh,
sure.
Shit.
Oh, wait, fucking.
All
right, sorry. Yeah. I'm like, all right.
Oh, wait, they're fucking. Wait, he leaves because they're fucking? That doesn't
yeah.
sound like Rizzy's character at
yeah.
all.
Yeah, right.
Like, hey, nice.
He didn't even ask if she was hot.
Yeah, he didn't even ask.
Well, I seen her already, didn't I?
Yeah, but is she still hot, though?
Yeah. Like, how does she look in that lighting?
I forgot. All right, fine. I guess I'll stay and look. I don't know.
Yeah.
All
right,
well.
Like, right.
What would Rizzy do,
I come
Casey?
Back.
What
would... I don't know. Then I come back, I'm like, yo, nice.
You fucking walk in and ask to join, obviously.
Wait, do I do that?
You can do whatever you want.
Come on.
Yeah, like, I mean, I guess, what? I don't know. I don't...
Do what you would do.
Yeah, there's okay. like six unoccupied women in that room. Come on, brother. It's an orgy
there,
waiting
I mean,
to happen.
I thought there was one.
Hopefully.
One,
hopefully.
He does have three of his wives just standing around the room.
Oh.
They're clapping.
But like,
yeah,
I'm still stuck.
Wives.
Right? Yeah, yeah.
Okay, so I'm like, you did it.
Okay.
So wait, which ends his wife today? Because it's a different wife every day.
That is true. He has a different wife for every day of the week.
Yeah. The one that's making him a meal.
Yeah, that's true.
Oh no. It's Thraka. Thraka's the wife.
No. Oh, no. Man, we needed to free this bitch.
Yeah,
we do.
Poor
okay,
thing.
So I guess you make your way into this room now. You do what you will.
he did it! Is he still stealth?
Yeah, he's stealth, yeah.
Holy shit. What a pervert.
Valinor's gonna wander off towards this one.
She took the hair, what a freak.
And be like, hey, what's going on?
Wow, what a old, that was old school.
Where'd Rizzy go?
Yeah, that was an old what a freak. That's a callback.
I never
yeah. Rizzy is
Alright, I'm gonna whisper to one of his wives, yo, they're really going at it, yo.
What is he doing?
Who said that?
Oh my god, da da da.
Okay.
Oh yeah, no,
he's the worst stealther ever. La da da da.
But their moaning is quite loud, so they can't really.
Oh, that makes sense. I thought it was quiet in here. What's it?
The heavy breathing.
No, they're not saying anything.
Which of his wives is the hottest one to Mook?
Oh my god.
That's subjective. That's subjective.
It is.
Well. Which one would I think is the hottest one? Are they all hot? I don't know.
What's your taste? Yeah. I'm gonna say
literally,
they
if they're a woman, it's hot to Rizzy.
They are all thin. They're all thin, dark-skinned woman with dark hair.
What's their facial expression?
They are all kind
disgust.
Of
holy shit.
Yeah, relative disgust to bored.
So can I? I'm gonna like I don't know. Throw a rock on the ground, one of them.
Okay.
I gotta pull a rock out of my pocket.
Yeah, alright. So what do you hope to accomplish stealth by throwing this rock?
Lord, she's gonna come and, like, investigate. You know,
stealth 101, always have a rock.
No!
Okay.
My direction.
So I'm gonna say roll for sleight of hand.
Jesus, okay.
Uh-oh.
You know, I wanted to leave, but you guys made me do this.
I didn't make you do anything. I was just surprised that you were gonna walk away.
I mean, I would have, but I guess
you. Yeah, KC would have, but would Rizzy have?
I don't know, man.
I think not.
I guess I'm not drunk enough to be Rizzy.
Oh, that's what's happening.
Yeah, it's
here,
sober
dude.
D&D night for everyone.
I got a natural.
I'm
one.
Drinking.
Oh my god. Okay.
Lucky
so
you.
Throw
oh
the rock
god.
Can I do that? Can
you
do
got
that?
A one.
Yeah,
can I
oh my god, he's gonna give one of them an eye patch,
yeah.
Dude.
No. You can be lucky. You can be lucky. You can re-roll, though.
Whoa, that's... where'd he get lucky from?
His racial.
Race.
Oh, yeah. God damn it.
We'll try again.
I mean, Jace, you have a similar thing, but you always forget to use it.
No. Yeah, because I like family.
Yeah,
it's like a new feeling for me.
True.
Plus 3, okay, 18. So
15.
18. Okay, so you throw the rock.
It's like a pebble.
And,
more like a pebble, yeah.
Yeah, the pebble. Okay, so she goes up to try to investigate. See you?
And I'm like, I guess I reveal myself. I was like, yo, you want to get out of here?
I reveal myself.
Okay, so
it.
When,
oh,
when you reveal yourself, she screams.
Oh, Jesus.
Shit. Everyone turns around. And the Sheik is like... Hey, what are you doing in my room? Messing with my wife.
Room.
I say,
my
room. Well, hello.
I swear, you little bunny bastard, I'll kill you. Oh. And then he grabs you. He grabs you by the collar.
Does anyone hear
the
screaming look in our
Dick's
room?
Dick's still out.
Does anyone hear this?
Yeah.
No. No.
God damn it.
And then he grabs you, and he's gonna do the old heave ho. Then just toss you out of his room. Like, whoa.
Okay.
Get out of here.
Get out of here.
And then he slams the door shut behind him.
Well, that was fun.
Hey, nice. Kona, where'd Rizzy go and what is up in here?
Who knows what that moron's doing?
Okay. I mean, that's fair, but what's up with the Gala? She does not look well.
Yeah, she doesn't. Can you turn around for 1 second? I thought I heard a noise over there.
Nope.
Wait, Mook, did I ever get the money?
Yeah, you did, yeah.
Oh, okay.
You did earlier,
never mind.
Right?
Okay, I didn't know if I got it or not.
Yeah, he got more money,
that's
though.
Way earlier. Oh, okay.
Yeah, I didn't know if I succeeded or not. I didn't do anything.
I would
Agalis is pretty much comatose at this point. She has no way to stop you.
I poked her, but like, she didn't respond.
So I'm not a doctor.
Kinda,
I'm gonna like lift her eyelids and start looking and stuff and try to figure out what's up.
Wait, Domri, I thought we were getting another drink.
Oh yeah, I finished mine already. I was coming to see what everybody was doing.
Oh shit.
I got 18 total.
I give Domri half. I give Domri half of the half of the money I just got.
Okay. Oh.
Hell yeah.
You can kind of feel that what is happening to Agalis is not natural.
Oh. Can I try to... I'm gonna go try to find Domri.
Yeah,
he's right behind you. He's behind you.
Oh my god. Okay.
Peekaboo, bitch.
Yeah.
So, something is going on here with Agalis. She's not well, and it... I think it's something magical.
You
know what's going on? Can you figure it out? It probably has to do with a ball effect, I'd assume.
I will check it out, yeah. What would you...
Be Arcana.
What would you like me to roll, Moon?
Yeah, roll Arcana.
Okay.
Okay.
Was that Bunny leaving or what?
Yeah.
Whoa.
Well, we lost somebody else.
No, that was just Bora.
Oh.
What?
What?
Oh, you just, quickly dropped.
Did I?
Yeah.
You did.
I did not mean to.
No, it's okay. It happens. Yeah, okay. So...
19.
19, okay.
Plus, I think that would be 24 total.
Okay, so... You look at her, and you also, you know, this is not a natural phenomenon, and you have the ball, right?
Well, I think it's actually in the bag of holding.
Okay.
The hole of holding.
I'm going to say right now that this is something you have never seen, but something you kind of feel like there's some kind of almost spell she is currently under right now.
Okay.
Like you can smack her, you can do whatever, but she is out cold.
Can I grab the ball out of the hole?
Yeah.
Okay, I'd like to grab the ball and like.
So the ball currently is glowing very brightly.
Okay.
It is shining. It is like a blue light right now.
Oh.
And you can feel it. It is not hot, but it is warm. Like you can feel that it is doing something.
Hmm. Interesting. Well, let's go ahead and get the ball away from Agalis.
Okay.
Nah,
so as you move the ball away from her, it dims. It slowly dims a bit.
Okay. Huh. Interesting.
But Agalis is still, she is still out.
Hmm. Okay. Well, this seems like it has to do with proximity, so... I guess I'll keep... What time is it right now? Is it like
Right
nighttime?
Now, it is... Yeah, it is past your guys' bedtime.
That is dire news.
Yeah, I'm gonna say it's like midnight.
I'm gonna put the ball like into my like tunic, so it looks like I have a big pregnancy bump.
Okay.
And then I'm gonna go back to the bar and keep drinking.
Oh shit!
Nice. Okay.
Does anybody go to drink with him?
Does anybody notice any effects from Agalis? As I
I'd be watching her as he takes the ball away.
Okay, as you go away, as you walk away, you can, Valinor, I'm gonna, what is your perception?
My passive is pretty high. Passive is 15.
Oh, okay, that is
high. I would be, like, watching.
Okay, so you can see her lips slowly move, and you go closer to her, and, you can hear her in her sleep slowly whisper the words, "I am all that I am."
Okay.
So she joined the army.
God. What a weakling. She's not ready to be a Marine yet.
Okay, fuck you.
Yeah, but
no, that's what Army stands for. Are we ready to be Marines?
Oh my God, you're gonna get shot.
That's fine.
Jace is sharpening his stabbing knife.
Yeah, I'm on
maybe
my
anti-military,
I'm on my
but
way.
My dad was a Marine. So.
I'm on my yeah, way. Yeah.
Okay, but yeah, but after she whispers that, she goes back to being just quiet.
Okay, I dedicate that to memory.
Yep, that is important.
I don't see anyone go with Domri to drink, so I'm not gonna let him drink alone.
Okay,
I dedicate that to memory. I don't.
They're sharing a drink. They call it. But it's better than drinking alone. Yeah.
This seems important. Better forget it.
Oh yeah. What a weirdo. Okay. You can't handle their booze.
All right. So at this point, Thraka, she is asleep. Everyone in the inn has either left or has gone to bed.
Wait, Thraka's gone?
She's here, but she's kind of dozing off in a chair in the corner.
Oh shit. Are we trying to see how much weight Domri can lift? What the fuck just happened?
Not much. You're both holograms.
Yeah, maybe. You know, I don't.
Did you say both telegrams?
Yeah, they're both. You're both telegrams, dude.
What do I say? What do I say?
I don't know.
I did drink my strength elixir.
Beep, 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 beep. Yeah, Julius is also asleep at this table too. So it's
now?
Like you guys are the only people.
Is this, is the
yeah.
water that was here still warm?
No, it is chilled.
God damn it.
Chilled? Yeah. Is it like 45 in here?
That 45 to me sounds very warm. So.
Oh, is
not.
It like 12 in here? I don't know.
Yeah, what is that?
I'm gonna say there is a big fireplace somewhere, so it probably is warm.
All right.
Okay.
Oh, it is warm?
Room temperature then.
Not the water, but the general temperature in the room.
What about the water? What's the water?
The water's like room temperature.
That's fine. I'm gonna go put his hand in it.
Okay. You can do so.
Okay, and then I'm done.
All right.
What color
are
Julius's robes?
They're brown.
Ooh.
They're like a monk's robes, like a friar.
Oh. Typically, friars do make things brown, so that makes sense.
Oh my God.
All right, boys. I'm done for the night.
Yeah, you guys.
Apparently,
you
we're
guys
killing
got
somebody,
an early
so
morning.
I'm gonna go to sleep.
Yeah, that's all Conan needs. We're killing somebody tomorrow. It's probably rich.
Somebody shitty.
Hell yeah.
All right, so
I like you guys. So I'm going to get one set of clothes, costume, three sets of clothes, sign, and one manacle. One set of manacles.
I don't. You know, I don't need the fine clothes and stuff.
Yeah.
Too much fun buying them.
Okay, I'm gonna say you actually at this point you probably have to go do that tomorrow before you get on the ship because it is midnight.
Oh, she left
guys...
a while ago though.
Oh, you did. Oh, mm-hmm. Sorry. Okay.
I'm outside here. That is what I said. Yeah.
So I am gonna say altogether that would cost you 5 solid.
Okay.
Lucky.
Alright.
Yeah. Well.
Alright, so you got your disguises. Okay, so I'm going to say that as of now, it is. And Aurora, would you say you have come back and gone to sleep?
Yeah, I probably would have just like come back straight and then went to sleep someplace.
Okay.
Whichever place has the least amount of people.
Yeah. So you guys, you have an early morning. So unless there is any objections, you guys go off to bed.
We only got 2 rooms, guys.
That is true, and one of them is full of crazy man writing, and the other
Domri
is covered
goes to sleep
in
somebody
vomit.
Else's room.
Yeah. It's just an old fat man sleeping in there. It's like, come over here.
Yeah. Yay, sleepy time.
Yeah, you guys are all in a big cuddle puddle.
Yeah, you know.
Don't sleep in the other room. The other room has puke in it. Don't sleep in that room.
Yeah.
Valinor was going to sleep in the girls' room because he's safe, but I guess there's puke in it.
He's safe. I like that.
Oh, yeah.
Can't trust that one or that one.
Yeah. Yohedva, she walks by as she hears you say that, and she just kind of like, oh, that's a shame.
Valinor refers to himself in the third person. He says,
"Is she joining our party?"
Is she joining? She is not as of right now. No, she's just kind of hanging around you guys.
We should get her to join the party.
Oh, she's our simp.
she kind of is. Yeah. I mean, you know.
Why the fuck are there cartoon rubber shoe noises?
I don't know. But yeah, they are also gone off
the head. Oh man.
Alright, so yeah. So I'm gonna say, imagine the sun and moon passing overhead, and then you hear the and it is now morning.
Imagine a Zelda.
Yeah, exactly.
Ocarina of Time.
Yep, there you guys go. You know what I'm talking about.
Yeah,
that was pretty cool. You know, so now it is early morning now. Thraka is frying up eggs, I guess, or something, and Garen, he's just kind of like looking around, I guess. He's like, you know, standing around drinking his cup of coffee. Julius, he is actually at this point going to comb up.
Is he moist?
Julius is, yes. He is moist. He's like, he's walking around the hallways like, oh no, my pantaloons.
He has pants on under that?
No.
yeah, it just keeps looping. It's funny. Yeah.
Okay, so you guys hear a knock on the door to your cuddle puddle. Knock, knock, knock.
Come in.
Knock, knock, knock. So then he comes, he's like, oh, hello, gentlemen. Rise and shine. What is that? Oh, groovy. Ah. I heard you all talking last night. You guys wanted to go to the temple this morning? Well, that's great, so do I. What a perfect fit.
I'm not waking up for this. Oh, God. Someone else.
Oh, come on now, Mr. Heathen.
Why do you keep calling him that?
Because he's a heathen? He's a heathen? My voice is wrong. Because he's a heathen of some sort, I'm
pretty
sorry.
Sure everybody here is.
Oh no, we're all good sons and daughters of the Pontifex, blessed be his name.
Listen, you're a heathen to me.
Well, it is Armalus, of course, the holy name.
Does that mean Agalus is like two-thirds holy? How's Agalus doing? I'm gonna check.
Agalus is still, and until Cataract comes back, Agalus is comatose.
I see.
well, since you asked, Agalus is from fine Remian stock, from born in the Holy Land. That means, I guess, she technically is.
You just refer to her as stock, Aurora.
I'm in the girls' room.
I'm yelling.
I heard her. I heard her say "fuck the Pontifex" one time.
I start pounding on the wall. Aurora!
I'm going to come in and I'm going to burst down the door and I'm going to say, where are they?
Slavers everywhere!
I point at this guy and say, this guy just called Agalus stock.
That's not her name, you dumb. No. It's Agalus.
I'm sorry. Miss Aurora. I was referring to her fine genetic breeding. That's all.
Oh, God. Don't you... Oh, that's just like the... That is disgusting! Don't talk about breathing!
No,
I'm talking about people!
I meant no offense.
That is weird.
I just meant I'm a filthy half-refame ogre beast.
I'm sure you didn't need any offense, and you definitely are filthy, but it's not because you're a half-ogre, it's because you're a shit.
yeah, whatever, pervert.
I'm sorry, well...
You look at butts and now you call women stock. Wow.
Oh just, my... He just kind of runs off.
That's 112 hail Armaluses.
Okay.
With a whip.
Yeah. Yeah, he has a rosary, and he's just like doing the rosary as he leaves. Like, oh, that would be the Domina Concordia and the Holy Father.
What do you want again?
Well, he was going to ask you if you guys were ready to go to the temple. because if you remember, you need him to go because he has the pass to use the fairies.
We'll find him.
Also now, from the other room, you just hear this loud kind of groan, like, I feel like shit.
Oh, she's the white.
You look great.
Wow, she survived.
You cannot see her because she's on the other side of a wall.
I know.
But it's just good to know that she's alive. I'm going to hand Valinor and Domri, and I guess I'm going to lay a set of fine clothes on top of the gal. So I'm going to give you all fine clothes.
Okay.
So that you can look like proper nobles.
Ooh, hey, and... well, oh, I mean, I can just disguise myself with a spell, but okay.
And I say, shh. Take clothes.
Oh wait, everyone click your long rest button in D&D Beyond if you have it. Before you fuck up. Okay.
All right.
Hey Mukathan, yep. I have a question.
Yes, I have an answer.
Maybe. So because I'm temporarily an Asimar in D&D Beyond, I customize my own shit.
Yes,
Asimars, right. Which are, you know, divine beings, kind
yes,
of.
Yes, yes.
They get, where is this thing? They get something I've been ignoring, but I just realized it might be relevant to Seraphim.
Okay.
They get a spell called Lesser Restoration, which basically can cure, like, a minor disease or condition.
Oh, that's cool.
I don't know if Seraphim would have that, but that's something.
Fuck it, why not?
All right.
Why not?
Just out of curiosity, because we also have no one to cure paralysis and shit like that.
Dacians get greater restoration, right?
Dacians get anything related to being trained to be a soldier, which
you can
I don't
restore
think that
weapon.
Would be. You can restore dishonor, but only to yourself if you live up to your superior officer's standards.
Okay.
Well, I'm going to give asking... summary. Like, it looked like some sort of a fancy lawyer suit, and I don't know, some fancy, like, 18th century gentleman suit with a top hat.
So if you were going for something actually in proper, it would probably be, like, white robes or something, like a fancy...
Somebody who looks like they handle paperwork, but is really expensive to, like...
So, like, some kind of fancy toga.
Yeah.
Okay.
Same with you. And I am going to put on my my gross costume.
So as you guys are doing that, Thorhilda comes into the room and she just looks at Agalus's passed out body and she just starts poking her.
Yeah, we don't know what's up with that. She doesn't look okay. I think she's dead.
Huh. And
finally,
she takes the clothes that were on Agalus, and she's like, well, these are mine now.
Oh no!
Are you going to be our white? Oh no, he's she.
Until Kat comes back, Thorhilda is going to be your backup, Agalus.
They look good. They look good on you. You look good in it.
They're very small.
Yeah, it's tight. It's nice.
Yeah, they're like bursting at the seams. Like, she can barely fit into it. And she still has these big horns on her head.
I was gonna ask if we should even do this without Kat, because...
You probably should not.
Okay.
Yeah, because between that and I don't have brain enough to RP a nobleman that's an asshole.
Fair enough.
Where'd your brain
go?
Well,
you guys can still go to the temple.
Where did your
brain
go?
You guys can still...
I
have it. I gave it to Jace the Minesweeper.
Yep. How about Jace?
I give it back.
Oh, nice.
How about Jace the Mind Sculptor?
Is that his name?
Either way, I give it back.
There are several.
Oh, okay. When I hear Jace's voice now, all I imagine in my head is Jace the Planeswalker talking.
So yeah.
Jace, wielder of mysteries. Jace,
ooh,
memory
true.
Adept.
Yeah. I use one of those.
Jace.
Oh, nice.
Yeah.
Hell
all
yeah,
the Jace
brother.
Cards are fun.
Jace Sexton.
Jace Arcane Strategist. Jace Architect of Thought. Oh my god, there's so many.
Architect of Thoughts?
Yeah.
Yes,
Jace
I build
Telepath
them up.
Unbound.
Alright. Well, even though Agalus is out cold, you guys can still go to the temple and check stuff out.
Okay, like we can prep and shit.
Why are we going
yeah,
to
I will like do that thing without Cap.
I will concoct a way for Agalis to be there with you guys when the time comes.
Cool.
Okay, so
we can. I put on my clothes regretfully.
All right.
And then
you guys...
use disguise self anyway.
Okay.
I'm just wearing the clothes that Aurora got for me in that disguise.
Okay, so what do you look like now, Valinor? What oh, like, does your face yeah. look different?
Yes, I will tell you in a second after I cast this and open my notepad. Alright, so I am... I'm using my name, Aurora, sorry. I am Adile Commodus. I'm
Adile.
A total asshole, very entitled, and whiny. I have tan skin, curly brown hair, hazel eyes, and a scruffy beard. I have a simple but fancy white toga with a red silk sash and belt, and a ceremonial scimitar encrusted with ruby to hide my rapier.
Nice, I like that. Okay, so as you guys walk up to here, Julius is like, Oh, I did not know you guys knew an Adile. Hello, sir. It is a pleasure to meet your acquaintance, and he does a polite bow. How may I be of assistance?
You can just take us where we're going.
Ah, all right. You know, I don't mean to be rude, Mr. Adile, but you remind me of a certain heathen I met once.
Is that so? Don't talk to me.
Oh, yes, of course, sir. All
right.
Okay. So, Rizzy, Aurora's going to hand you a weapon of some sort.
I'm
going
to hand you my maul and say... please give this back to me when the time is right. And I'm going to take my little knife out of it and find a place to hide it in my disgusting thing.
Yeah. Okay.
For a second, all I saw were the words tactical American. Well, that was loading.
God damn.
Okay.
What a great last thing to see.
Whoa.
Yep. So, you guys, you left the inn and you aboarded the ferry.
Where the fuck am I?
You have been transported to the temple district. In front of you, you see, even though it is early, you see a large crowd kind of like lined in a queue, and they're all going like into one of these. You're holding Bora's hammer. They're going into one of these column gateways here. Where did I put the ship? And you see like large golems looming over and walking around, and even from here you can see the massive temple, which is by far the biggest building in this city. And also now you can see just tons of military people and like officials of all sorts just kind of gathered around. Where is? Here we go. Band. What was the ship I used?
The Zanara.
No, I know, but I don't have it here. I need to.
Oh, God. There we go. The cruiser?
Yeah, it was that.
Where the fuck? Is it inside the. Nope. Oh, it was in your. Oh, yay!
And this is just. I don't know. It is here. And you can see the fancy ship, and it is
good enough.
Parked. It is parked there.
Okay. And it's actually a different ship.
Is it?
Yeah.
Oh, well,
kind of looks like a dick.
It works.
All right.
A little bit, but like a real weird one.
A real weird dick.
Well, that's fitting. It's like, well, my friends, I have business to attend to with the Council of Hierophants. Hopefully, I can get an audience with the Consul. And maybe they will know where the missing people from Amalka went. Oh, I'm so excited. So Julius, he walks past the crowd, and he is allowed entrance into the temple.
Were we intended to follow the man?
He kind of thought you would.
Okay, yeah, we...
But really, you guys are free to do what you will.
Okay. What was our intent here besides boarding the ship?
I wanted to look around. If there's anything you do, you can see what's over in here. There is a large crowd going into here. I will say you guys still have time. You still have time before like an hour. before you have to get on the ship.
Okay.
An hour? I have to be wearing this for a whole hour?
Longer than that.
Yep.
It shows off your abs.
What were you going to ask, Rizzy?
Is there, like, a weapons shop or armory?
Well, as you know, this is an ecclesial temple, there is probably an emporium in here, which would sell all sorts of hyper-advanced machinery. Like, if you wanted to purchase maybe some kind of robotic limb, or some sort of, I don't know, hoverboard?
Right, never mind.
yeah. But actually, you know what? I'm gonna say Julius is like, "Oh, come along, gents. Don't you wanna see all of the goings on?"
Not all of us are gents.
Yeah.
Look at these motherfuckers.
It is up to you, Valinor, I guess.
Yeah.
What is your name again?
Adile Commodus.
Adile Commodus.
Just call me Adile, I guess.
Adile, yeah, that is his title. That is the title of a city councilor.
Yep.
Okay. But yeah, really, you guys are free to do what you want right now.
Yeah.
While you look around.
Just looking around out here, there's nothing out here. Valinor, or I guess Adile Commodus would follow.
Okay.
I'm gonna go look around over here and see if I see anything.
From right here, Domri, you notice the vastly advanced machinery of the golems, the Union's golems, and as a man who can get with some machines, you are quite impressed. And you see some church-esque architecture outside, and a bunch of legionaries just standing around, kind of, you know, just taking patrol.
Hell yeah!
And also from here, you can see some large, even larger golems for all on the other side of the temple walls.
Oh dear. Well, alrighty. So, is there anything like I can discern from these golems? Like, as far as, like, new architecture that I wouldn't have seen before?
Yes, you can tell that these are all state-of-the-art. These are new. These are all brand-new golems. Hmm. And you can kind of figure that they must have been made in preparation of something.
Oh, neato.
Kind of like you get the hint that some shit is about to go down.
Ah, okay. Well, I will take note of that mentally.
Okay. I'm gonna ask you to do a perception check right now.
Okay. Well, that's just passive, right? That's not a roll.
Yeah.
Okay. I'm pretty sure my perception is like pretty high. Yeah, it's wisdom plus my perception skill bonus.
Yeah.
That's 19.
Oh, okay. So that's perfect.
Whoa. What?
What?
Hold up. No. How do you have plus 9 perception? Are you like double proficient?
It's 10 plus your perception bonus.
Yeah.
Oh,
that's how passive works.
I thought it was your wisdom plus your 4 for passive.
So, is the so 10 plus your proficient.
So 14.
Yeah. Okay, that's fine. 14, that's still above 10. So you, you hear a loud boom. And from over the top of that wall, you can see kind of a pillar of smoke. You discern that the sound is probably the sound of some kind of engine blowing. It is a sound you are rather familiar with.
Oh, ruh-roh. It's on the other side of this wall.
Yeah.
Okay. Can I look through these like little door holes or windows?
No. There would be no actual things there. Those are just for flavor. But you are free to go through here.
Ah, okay.
Because Julius had the pass, the amulet that lets you guys all past. And also, Aurora. I'm gonna say Aurora probably has to stand close to Commodus, and people are currently like looking at her in disgust as they walk by.
I'm not going to go without like 5 feet of Commodus.
Okay. So Domri, in here now, you see a bunch of priests decked out in artificer gear. They are all running around and kind of screaming in panic over this large white mech that is its shoulder is smoking, mm-hmm. and there is sparks flying from it. And also in front, you can see a short girl creature who is currently running back and forth looking for the proper tools that she currently does not have to fix.
They're called women, Mook? Not girls, no, creatures?
No,
creatures.
No.
Can I roll to, assume which tool she's looking?
Yes, you can.
Cool. Okay, I'll just do that. Because I might have it.
Yes. So I'm gonna say you would roll Arcana for now until I actually figure out how to implement a tinkering skill for you, which is what I think I should do.
Okay. That is a 7 plus 5 is 12.
Okay, so due to the nature of and location of this malfunction, you can tell that it is probably an electrical problem. So you think that this girl is looking for a pair of pliers or something that can work with the wiring.
Okay, well, I'll grab my pliers out of my tools and ask her, hey, you look at these?
So, as you come up to her, she looks up. She is very small, probably only up to your waist, maybe something
Perfect.
Around there. And she like, oh, thanks, big guy! That's exactly what I was looking for!
It's okay, I'll hand it to her, and then I'll see what she does.
Alright, so... she... gets on a, I don't have it out here, but there is a lift machine that raises her up, and she hops onto the shoulder and she begins to kind of, make do. She's fixing a few things, and then the golem shoulder, it stops smoking, and the kind of loud noise you were hearing kind of dies down. So then she wipes some sweat and grease from her shoulder, and she hops back down. It's like,
oh, thanks, man, or thanks, sir. Mm-hmm. You sure are a cool big guy. You really saved us.
Yeah, no problem. I saw you were in need and figured I'd help since I had my tools with me.
Oh, are you an anchorite too?
No, not exactly. I just I dabble.
Oh wow, you really know a lot about machines, big guy. Well, my name's Evelyn. Pleased to meet you.
No, pleased to meet you too. Now, would you mind if I got those pliers back if you're done with them?
She looks a little embarrassed, but she's like, "Oh, yeah, of course."
All right.
So then this guy's gonna come up. He's like, "Oh, Yavalan, why are you talking to strangers?"
Oh, he's not a stranger. He's very kind. He helped us with the golem over here.
Oh, I don't know about that. Look at him. What is he? Kind of smells like one of us, doesn't he, Evelyn? It's like,
oh, stop smelling strangers, Eugene. That's very rude.
Oh,
it's okay.
Stop smelling strangers, Eugene. You sure are a tall one, aren't ya? But you look like a... Wait, Mr. Sir, Mr. Sir?
Yes.
Do you happen to be of Norling descent?
Yeah, a little bit.
Wow.
Wow, big guy, you're so cool.
Well,
how did a Norling get so big?
Well, there was some secrets involved, but that sounds like a story for another time.
Oh. So they are quite taken with Domri. They think he is a the coolest shit.
Is this chick hot?
Roll.
I'm
gonna
need a
cutie. Rizzy to roll.
Actually, did I have? Where was it?
Rizzy is on the roof taking notes.
Rizzy is creeping on this small woman.
Did we move as a group, or did we all just move solo into this place?
Domri went in because he heard the malfunction. What you guys were doing is up to you.
I'm just sticking with
the Domri went in because lucky old W.
I'll get the roof.
Yeah, exactly, as he should. Okay, and Rizzy is creeping on the roof.
Doing nothing.
No, I'm actually on the roof.
He's doing nothing.
I think I had one for her. I didn't use all the other ones I had. Yeah, here we go.
Alrighty, I will return to the group then.
There we go. Okay.
After telling them goodbye and whatnot, exchanging pleasant
dreams. Get a number?
Well, you know.
I don't know.
Not gonna give her everything all at once. Just drip feed her.
So as Domri goes to leave, the girl comes running back. She's like, wait, big guy, I didn't get your name.
Oh, it's Domri.
Oh, Domri. Yeah. All right, Domri. She puts out her hand. She stretches it up to shake yours.
Oh, jeez. Excellent. I'll grab it in between my thumb and my index finger.
Yeah.
And I will shake it.
Like, well, Papa back home will never believe that I saw such a big man.
She's hooked.
Of course.
She goes hooked, back. Man. All right. So that happened.
Yeah. The Aedile, I guess, would just kind of walk in with Rizzy, apparently. One of the bodyguards.
Who am I supposed to be a bodyguard to?
Me.
I'm just walking with him. Yeah, I'm walking too.
Okay.
Yeah.
So in here you see a large crowd of people going into, lining up to go into this building, and then there's some these other two buildings here also have people lined up. You see also tons of people in various sorts of white robes. I think Lucky is starting to know what I had planned for his character.
Solidify my place in legend.
The Amazonas and the fucking dwarf. Let's go. Oh no. God, Domri is my ex-stepdad. he had a thing for the short ones.
Well, you know.
Yeah. Alright. When you guys go in here, you see there is, at the temple gates, there is a small group of very ostentatiously dressed guys. Who Julius is trying to talk to, but they aren't giving him much attention.
I'll log over. Like, hello there, is there a... Oh, real quick, DM. Could we tell... Do we have to go through the building to board, or is it off
the
side?
No.
The building is just for, like, prayer, right?
It is for a ton of stuff, place. but nothing that is relevant to you right now.
Okay.
You would know, Valinor, that the guy who rules this city is probably in here somewhere.
Oh.
Oh, you know what? Actually, out here too, you are going to see... I'll use these guys for it. There is two guys arguing, standing in front of the temple. It's one of these guys and then like a soldier guy.
They're arguing over the bones on the floor. Are Harispex do that, right, or is it the guts?
It's the guts. In this universe, Harispex are the healer priests who do shit with the human body, and the Anchorites do stuff with machines.
They heal the human guts.
Yes.
Instead of killing and reading them. Okay.
Yeah, exactly.
Okay, so they're arguing?
Yeah, they're arguing.
Well, I guess so. I wouldn't have gotten to those two quite, but I'd kind of be like witnessing.
Okay, so you can see the guy in armor. He is pointing at the temple, and the guy he wants to get in, and the guy's like, he keeps trying to assure him, like, oh no, please, I'm sorry, it's not up to me, but the consul Lord Arius, he says he will not meet with the senator today. That is preposterous! How could he refuse an order from the Senate? I'm sorry, sir.
The Senate. I am the Senate,
not I'm yet. Sorry, sir, but the consul will not be taking an audience today. And he goes back inside the temple.
I use message on that man who's leaving and just say, do it!
What? sorry. Is this God? Yes, God, I will do it. Wow, a revelation. And this guy, you can tell he runs off very happy now.
Nice. What is he gonna do? I'm scared now.
I don't know what he's gonna do.
He's gonna go like stab someone.
Pedophilia is now legal.
No. Oh. Like the last thing he was thinking about, just like some fucking intrusive thought. And his brain just hears God say, "Do it."
Yeah.
Oh, no.
Nice job, Balnor.
You don't know what's up.
This soldier, with Centurion, you can kind of see him shake his head and curse under his breath, and just kind of like, goddamn praetors.
Excuse me, sir.
Ah, he sees your outfit. He's like, hail Adile.
And tell me, what was that about?
Salutes. Yes, sir.
Quickly, please.
Well,
I apologize. Just quickly.
Okay, I've been tasked by his lord, the senator, Quintus Publius Superbus, blessed be his name, to come and fetch the consul in order to bring him to the meeting. It is utmost imperative, but it appears I'm being stonewalled.
This is...
I fear,
interesting information. Okay.
I fear I will be reprimanded by the senator. He does not appreciate failure such as this, but what am I to do? I'm sure you know when the praetors squabble amongst themselves, there is little us folk can do to
sink indeed.
Their appetites.
Had my fair share of praetors being not great to people even of my position.
Yes, I imagine so. I mean, I don't mean to blaspheme, but it is what it is. And
it's the human condition. Or praetor condition, but you know.
The praetor condition. Okay. And he goes back off towards the ship.
Alright.
Here. I'm gonna say, yeah, these guys are guarding the entrance to the ship, and there are
Which way? These two?
Yep.
Okay.
And these fancy looking guys who were ignoring Julius, they begin to line up.
I just walk in the temple.
Okay.
I don't. I don't wish to actually meet with this man or even attempt to.
Okay.
Wait a minute.
Valen, are we...
Yep, Rizzy?
Is there anywhere I can get more arrows or should I have done that earlier? If there isn't, that's fine.
Here, probably not, but okay, because Agalus is in a comatose state, you could, in theory, just go back to the city and buy some.
Never mind.
Yeah, you could buy bullets and stuff in the Ankhorum, but probably not.
Go buy some bullets.
I'm not gonna buy bullets.
Do it.
Well, I can sell stuff though, right?
I'm gonna say yes, you could sell stuff at... It depends what.
Oh, actually, if they're only doing like technical stuff, never mind.
Yeah. It is like a fantasy Best Buy in there.
Never mind.
Overpriced.
Here's your shitty speaker system and your graphics card from 2013.
Carry on. Never mind.
8 billion 4K TVs, none of which have any sort of color correction.
And then the other side, you see a lineup of like a sick. Looking people and like maybe some injured people and like getting wheeled in and a stretcher and, yeah. and there are like these Haruspec priests they're like tending to the people who are all sick and stuff.
Interesting. What are these two side buildings? They just have like
these are what we call decoration.
Yeah, they're some baths.
I don't know. I just put them there because I thought they looked cool.
I just said that. You put your feet in the pool and like you feel good.
Oh yeah, sure. Yeah, actually, yeah, they're little pools.
Foot baths, yeah.
Yeah.
Okay. They're working on a big mechy boy right next to a pool of water. There's just oil in this foot bath.
Yeah. Thank goodness, Lucky gave Evelyn the tool to fix it.
It's not dripping oil.
No.
Yeah, he's efficient. Doubt Domri's handiwork.
Yep.
Evelyn's dripping is Domri's handiwork.
Exactly. As you guys are all here, and these little nerds, they're just kind of like looking at all you guys, like, oh, big. You can see they're kind of talking about concepts like quantum mechanics and things nobody else would understand. Mm. They're arguing about anime.
All right, Mook. Let's say theoretically go back.
Wait, Mook.
Let's say I theoretically go back and buy arrows and stuff. Right.
Like, does Valinor?
You can just retcon it that you did it before, Rizzy.
Yeah. I don't care. Well, I will say that you did it before.
So I have a spear.
Yeah. Well, we're down in the black market.
Oh, you have for arrows. Yes, you have that big, huge arrow, right?
No. I'm gonna sell like one spear that I have for arrows.
Oh,
that magic spear.
How many arrows will you get from that?
Oh.
You would get all.
You would get. I would say that spear that was the plus one. Spear would get you 50 solid eye.
50 solid eye. And then
and now I need to know how much is an arrow?
Cheap.
Dark sling.
So 50 solid
price for arrow.
It'd be like a bunch of arrows, probably. Probably times.
Yeah.
What if I just want to buy like 20 arrows and I'll save the solid eye?
Okay, that's fair. Oh, here we go. Wait, no. Longbow, but not an arrow. Fucking thing has everything except for the stuff I need. Back here, the stupid pamphlet. Okay.
Arrow catching shield.
Yeah, basically, so how much is one arrow?
Yeah, that's what I'm looking up.
Oh, I could do something like that.
You just fake being a monk.
It's
from Rise of Tiamat.
Okay, I'm gonna say.
Bad bitch.
One bundle of 20 arrows is 1 gold, it looks like.
Good damn.
Which is one
that covers to how many?
One solid eye.
Solid eye.
One solid eye? Okay,
one
so
Sephiroth.
I can buy 40 arrows in.
Where are these motherfuckers getting money from?
He just sold the spear.
I just sold a spear.
Oh, yeah, he sold a magic spear.
And then I have 48 solid eye, so, okay.
You have 48 gold?
Yeah.
How the fuck do I only have 5 Aurelius?
Right, you didn't pick up anything magic to sell. You looked at the spear and said, nah, man.
So I have 40 solid eye and 51 arrows. That's
this money shit is fucked.
I slipped the bodyguard in black.
Alright, that's it for me.
Let's
13?
Okay. No, let's go with 7 solid eye, actually.
Okay.
Well, I look at Conan like, yo, you know, if you need me a spy for anything, I got you.
This is all retcon. You're not even buying the arrows right now.
Conan, yeah. You have 7 of the gold currency.
Oh, hell yeah.
I just gave it to you.
Hell yeah.
Nice.
There.
I'm still keeping what I stole from a gal.
Yeah, I mean, she's a vegetable. She doesn't need it. What's she going to sell?
We don't know about the healthcare energy. They might need that money, or they'll unplug her.
Well, I mean, if you guys want to know about the healthcare here, you can. It's right there. You can check it out.
True. I will ask Aurora. Hey,
I'm going to go and
this is your plan.
Healthcare.
Okay.
Okay. So you go in there.
Well, that means we all go because you're our slave.
Oh yeah, that's true.
Just
yeah.
Tell me what to ask because I guess I'm in charge.
As you walk by there, you can hear people being like audibly disgusted by Aurora's appearance.
You all hush.
Audibly disgusted.
My slave.
I just want to know how that works, what they do, and how they heal.
So in there, it is a large open building. There is like little what do you call them? Cubicles separated by, you know, curtain, and you can see they're kind of open up though, and you can see people laying on beds
covered in leeches.
No, not leeches, no. Priests are running around. Some are injecting various chemicals into their bodies to heal them, and there are large, in some of them, like mechanical creatures with like arms coming down from the ceiling, a la Star Wars, the Return of the Revenge of the Sith, that are kind of like operating on people. And at the back, there is like a guy behind a counter, and there's like just a bunch of different potions and stuff.
Is there anyone that looks in critical condition?
Yes, there is.
I'm going to like try to walk up to them sneakily so nobody can see.
I'm gonna say roll for
I would be walking with her, so I mean, it should be
Yeah, oh, okay. I just so that the other ones can't see.
I'd just be inspecting.
So in front of their a priest asks you to stay back, that they are performing critical. A 20 what?
I rolled 17 plus 3, so 20 is for stealth.
Oh, okay, so they can't see you, but they can still see the Commodus.
It's more like they just eyes glaze over. Like,
yeah, yeah, yeah. Okay, they're just like they're preoccupied. This guy's stomach is opened up, and they're just kind of in there.
Well, I stay maybe like 6 feet away. I'm just like, oh, that looks messy.
And they're like operating.
Yeah, what is wrong? What is wrong with this man that you're doing here?
What is the problem? And none of them are paying attention to you. They're all preoccupied with the operation.
I am an Aedile, and you will answer me.
Okay, so the guy, he drops his scalpel, and he turns around, and he does the Roman salute. He's like, hail, sir. How can we help
you? Get back to work and talk. Tell me what are you doing? What is happening here?
This man has a tumor in his stomach, sir. We're removing it.
Oh, interesting. I haven't seen many surgeries where I'm from.
Yes, well, I see the Lord has blessed you with good health.
As far as I'm aware.
Yes, yes.
Reappear behind the Commodus. Behind Commodus.
Okay, one of them, oh wait, you're still stealth, so yeah, no one's gonna notice you.
Yep, Aurora's just gray manning, or whatever the fuck it was called.
Yeah.
I ask her, do you get your look? You're good?
Oh yes, I'm good. Thank you. Thank
okay. You. Okay. They what, Mukuthin?
Oh, I was gonna say that you see them sewing up the guy's stomach now, and they're cauterizing it, and as they do, there is a blue liquid that they inject into him, and the guy just kinda like he seizes up and just kind of like tenses up and like, ugh! And then goes back down. And then the priest, he kind of sighs and he's like, oh, good.
What was that you just injected him with?
That was Aurelianum. It is a chemical composition of the human genome meant for swift healing. We offer it at this temple. For all who can afford it.
I may have to get some of that to take back to my city. All right, I'm just gonna walk away.
Okay.
Just all snobby like.
Okay. They are probably used to important looking men being snobby to them, so they don't mind.
Yeah. Okay.
They probably take it as a compliment, knowing these people.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So. We're waiting for a Gallus to go on the ship.
Yep. So I think we're kind of at a stone wall. So unless you guys just want to fuck around in the temple courtyard for a while.
What's up?
Was that blue stuff lead?
Station
cream.
I mean, like, can I roll?
Yeah, that's
my
the other thing.
To see if I remember what it's
cream
made out of.
Lead.
You can.
I would. I Valinor is joking. He would have guessed too. Because maybe.
Are we doing session tomorrow?
I don't know. I think it's up to the people who need to. Yeah, it's up to High Blast and Cat because like we didn't even get close to what I thought we would be doing today. I thought we would be doing a dungeon today.
Well, Kessnant,
Cat kind of.
Imploded.
17.
Cat hasn't even responded in Discord. Like Cat's gone.
I think his internet literally just pooped.
So at 17, you have an idea that is probably made out of some kind of laboratory-born enzyme and chemical composition related to.
Does the chemical composition have any lead in it, though?
Probably not. No, it probably just has like various elements like
mercury.
Yeah, since... I don't know how medicine is made.
Since Cass, I don't think we should do the temple things.
They don't use lead.
No, definitely
medicine.
Not.
At least not this medicine.
Probably not good medicine, but I'm not. Maybe they do. I don't know. I'll read up on lead eventually.
Certain,
anti-magical weapon properties that can be used, like if somebody gets shot with a magical arrowhead or bullet, and it's stuck in them and they need to remove it, they can use a lead-based tools to, you know, not infect the area with any sort of, like, magic.
Ooh, interesting.
But wouldn't silver work just as well?
No, silver would enhance the magic and...
Oh.
You want to know what lead is, Valinor? I shoot him.
You shoot copper.
Wait, look, is there anything you use at Emporium?
What, Casey?
Is there anything I could use at the Emporium?
You can go check it out. There is, an Emporium is where they sell machinery.
Right, yeah, I'm saying, is there anything I use or not?
Where the fuck is the Emporium?
Maybe. It's right over here.
Just make sure, we're in care, we're, what do you call it, undercover right now.
Yeah.
Yeah.
That is true, you should probably
You're a bodyguard
by...
of this dude.
Yeah. We'll follow you, but yeah.
Yeah, just let us know. We're, you know, like, shopping right now.
Fine, I won't shop there.
Just saying, don't blow our cover, because otherwise we have to kill everybody, and then cover's blocked.
Yeah.
There's a lot of...
So when you get up to the Emporium, you see a lot of those canisters of Sarkic.
Okay.
These big glass tubes of, like, black goo. And then there's just like, it's like you enter into a big open air workshop, just like machines, like engines, various golem parts. You see a guy sitting on a table or sitting on a chair by a table, and he is getting a robotic arm fitted onto his shoulder. And then there's just like various priests running around with like, what do you call them? Like torch guards and blow torches, just kind of like fixing things together. Then, as you go in there, this guy, this other little nerd, he's like, "Oh, hello, fellows. How may I help you?"
We're just perusing for now, I suppose.
Oh, I see, I see. Guess well, I also enjoy looking at this wondrous technology. Isn't it amazing?
Would Domri be? I assume Domri would be over here.
Domri, right now, I will say he is probably pretty in his element here.
Yeah.
Static.
He's like, "Oh, this is a 13-inch sprocket, which would fit into this thing
yeah.
that I like."
What about Kona?
Yeah, I got 13 inches.
Sprocket?
Around.
13-inch rocket.
That explains... That explains how often you just, like, fall over.
Yeah.
Like, you see a woman, you just fall over. That's why you always fail your stealth.
Yep. it's a blessing and a curse.
You just pass out.
Well, you technology boys enjoy.
Are we?
Meanwhile, I look at a gun, I'm like, what is this?
What is gun?
I'll show you.
What is
going to find the thing that looks the most springy and just mess with it.
Okay, you find a spring.
I'm going to spring it.
Okay.
Has it been sprung?
It has been sprung. As you do it, a priest walks up to you and just like, no, filthy mutant. Don't touch this.
She's quite clean, I make sure of it.
And I just turn to him and I say in Ishik, I do not understand the word of dumb men.
He just kind of like looks at you in disgust, and he goes to Commodus. He's like, you really should keep a better hands on your mutant slaves.
She won't break anything here. Do you think she could break anything? It's all metal.
I'm literally wearing a set of manacles as well.
I wouldn't want to get her filth on the Nephilim's holy relics. It would be disrespectful for such a creature to touch something so divine.
You
I
would like to talk
into Valinor. I do the like spit the thing where you're like, "Oh, this guy's crazy!" Like spinning.
And
I would not like to talk to one such as yourself anymore. Farewell.
Oh my!
And I keep staying there. I expect him to leave.
He just kind of like looks confused, and he just shrugs and walks off. Like, whatever.
Yeah, and then I leave after that. Unless people have more stuff to do here. Like, I guess Rizzi was looking around, but
I just look around like a boomer. Like, what are these technologies, yo?
Yeah. What is okay. this? It's a laser cannon.
Is there anything that I could even use? Like, I don't think so, right?
They have all sorts of stuff in there. I don't know if anything you could use in combat. Yeah, probably not.
So I'm just like, oh, what is...
You see like a bunch of prosthetic body parts. Like, you see a pair of prosthetic eyes. You see a prosthetic leg in there. Jeez, and you see, and then walking out of the back, you see a dude who's like, he's mostly robot. Like, he's got, he's kind of new fist looking.
Oh, no. ghost in the shell, like.
Yeah, exactly.
I was like, all right, cool. And I go up.
Okay, right. I will mention that I wish to go talk to those guards outside the ship dock.
Okay.
To people. So I would start heading that way if all right. unless other people want to do things here.
I'm just following my charge.
I wait for the technology people, but I'm just standing outside.
Like if Domri's doing a thing, I feel like Domri could just stay there and do his own thing.
Yeah, like I just wait.
Like Domri's probably alright.
Yeah.
He is our warrior.
I wait for them to look at their heart's contents and then.
Yeah.
I mean I would also, you know, stand around and wait, but I don't think so, there's too much there for us.
Yeah, so as you guys head over, you hear someone call over, Domri, come here for a second. We're having an argument. And this guy's like, oh, don't consult him. Domri, what do you think is more effective? The 12th generation flame engine or the 20X hyperpower. He's like, no, obviously it's the hyperpower. What does this guy know? Domri!
What was that?
They want to know what your favorite kind of engine is.
My favorite kind of engine?
You just made up words, so
the
go
famed
ahead.
300 cylinder.
And she's like, oh! He's like, oh, interesting. Mm-hmm. they just come back to like whispering amongst each other, like, oh, whatever.
Can I ask them what their favorite is? Or did they run off?
Another bear, and they both turn around and they at once they say the same one you said.
Oh, hell yeah. Can I get some fist bumps?
They're like, oh,
Oh my god. They're the troll things from Toy Story, Story, the aliens. Ooh, I can't do that, but.
No, they're just
claw.
Nerds. Yeah. they're just turbo nerds.
Turbure nerds.
I mean, yeah, actually, kind of.
they're not virgins.
At least not for long.
They are most certainly are. Especially this guy. Especially
well, the guy Eugene. Is. Yeah, the guy is.
Yeah. Eugene, even though Eugene.
His name
has
is Eugene,
a,
come on.
He has a 3000 IQ, but he doesn't know how babies are made.
Yeah. Wait, how are babies made?
Yeah, Rizzy would not know.
No, I would know.
Yeah,
he saw it last night.
I'm just going to turn to Rizzy and be like, when a mommy loves a daddy, or just whenever, they fuck. No, and then they make a little
I wouldn't know.
He was confused. He's like, why are they hugging so hard? That's what he would have said last night.
Oh, I see.
Oh. I know why they're hugging.
Because it's cold out.
Yeah, of course. No, because they're fucking. I look at...
Fucking cold.
I look at Conan, I'm like... Fucking.
Oh, no. Yeah, no, we weren't even having this conversation. You just say it out loud. Fucking.
So as you stand there, Rizzy, little Evelyn, she kind of runs up and she's like, "Hey, Mr. Fuzzy, I like your big ears. They're
hey,
really
Mr.
cute.
Fucky.
They remind me of a little bunny."
Oh, well, why? Thank you, little one.
And then she just kind of giggles and runs off back to the robot. I'm like, man, these people are fucking weird.
Well, I see her as a child, so I just walk off to you.
She's a fully grown adult.
Yeah, but I see her as a child, so.
Okay.
Racist.
Yeah.
No.
All right.
Racist,
so,
not
so
about
yeah.
them short stacks.
As of now, you guys can honestly just do what the fuck ever, because we can't get by without Agalus.
I want to kill Eugene.
I was going to ask the guard.
You want to kill Eugene?
Fucking nerd.
Eugene.
Okay, I'm going to say, Kona, if you want.
No. I'm
him.
Just...
You can just, like, flick him a bit or, like, give him a wedgie.
No.
Where's Val?
I'm used to that.
I'm undercover. I'm not doing anything.
Okay.
Where is Valinor?
Over Valinor. Next to the ship guards. Where
yeah.
was
I'm staying wherever Valinor is.
Yeah, I go to Valinor.
Okay. Yeah.
This is like the entrance.
I'm his
to
shadow
the ship
right
or
now.
Whatever.
Yeah. So there you see a large crowd. Well, I guess not large, but a crowd of like very fancy, important looking guys with robes, and they're all waiting to get onto the ship, and there are two centurions guarding the entrance.
Okay, I would just walk by everyone, talk to the centurion off to the side.
Citizen.
Citizen's a weak word. Hi there. Is there, by chance, another time to board the ship?
We are boarding in 30 minutes, sir.
Will it happen to be landed again sometime today?
Today, sir? Well, that is most unorthodox, but...
I'm sorry, sir. It is his wife. She has come down since...
Don't talk to me, mutant filth.
You don't talk to my mutant filth like that, you scum.
I apologize, sir.
I'm just wish to relay the message aboard, of the great and powerful.
Ideal. My wife has been... or has fallen ill today. We have her being seen to shortly.
I see. Well... I mean, between you and me, sir, we're supposed to be leaving in 30 minutes, but with the consul not showing up to board, we're kind of at an impasse. I think things may be delayed a bit, but I can't say for how long.
Interesting. Okay. That is good information. Thank you. And goodbye.
Yes, citizen. And he steps back.
Hoo-ah, indeed.
Yeah.
No! All right. My retinue has fallen!
Oh, shit.
Oh, fuck.
Yeah.
There you go. Well, I mean, Valinor did think of things to do back in that merchanty place.
Okay.
If we have time to go all the fucking way.
Yeah,
there.
Yeah. I'm gonna say you guys have time to do whatever. Things have obviously changed because Kat's not here, so it's like, I don't know.
Yeah. Yeah.
So you guys can go on your own little misadventures. If you guys want to go hang out with Chattius, if you want to go take a bath, you guys want to...
Valinor would like to go get that Allosaur tooth appraised at many shops.
Okay.
Are we leaving?
I guess we are.
Are we on a timetable for this thing?
It was delayed.
You are, but the ship is delayed.
Oh, the ship
the console...
is delayed.
Yeah, the ship is delayed because the consul won't leave his confines of the temple. Oh, that's okay, Jace. Everyone pees.
Yeah, had to go.
I'm going to whisper in Valinor. Can we stop back at the place before very quick? I need to train.
Absolutely not. Yes, we can.
Okay. So when you go up to the ferry, somebody asks you for a pass.
You're asking an Aedile for a pass.
My apologies, sir.
Are you sure about that? You better let us on, or else I will tell you, Commander.
I'm going to say roll for persuasion.
What are we getting on the ferry for?
Just to go somewhere else. Because
Is
that how
here
we got here?
Yes, it is how you got here. Okay. But Julius was with you.
Okay.
So just persuasion, no nothing about it?
Yeah, just persuasion.
Because I'm an Aedile? All right.
Well, that helps, that helps.
Okay, well, 13 then.
Okay, that's good.
All right.
So the guard he stands aside and he lets you on. He's like, sorry, sir.
And all my retinue, slave included.
Of course, sir. What about Domri?
Domri lives here now.
Domri is hanging out with his new friends. I guess.
Domri, what you doing? You just doing that?
I'm gonna hang out.
All right, see you later. And then we never saw Domri again. We just leave.
We'll catch up.
No.
Domri becomes the Senate.
Not
Domri's the big dad at the end.
Oh my god.
Alright. But yeah, Valinor will tell everyone he wishes to go back to the markety place we went and just kind of give a big tooth appraised. After going back to the inn to get the short one her clothes.
Thank you. I'm just going to say I changed my clothes.
Oh, this is the one I used. Well, what the fuck?
Yeah.
Why do I have it on this one and not the one it was supposed to be on? Whatever, I'll fix that.
Yeah. That does look... Whoa. Oh, God. Ooh. That was a lot of noises. That does look a lot more party, too, than the other one.
Yeah, doesn't it? It looks like it's got a strobe light going
like
on inside.
Disco stuff. Yeah.
Yeah, that's why... Yeah, okay.
More neon.
You guys are back home. Well, not home, but you're in familiar... Oh, shit. You're in familiar territory.
I mean... Kona could be in familiar shit.
Yeah, yeah.
Maybe.
You see, you know, there are people coming and going, living it up.
I'm also going to hide my tail again, just, you know.
Okay. So yeah, if you want to go back inside the inn and change, you're free to. If you want to do literally anything else here, you are free to. Just kind of killing time. Fill out some time.
I want to go into the leather worker downstairs, but I can wait.
Okay.
I mean, that's roughly where I'm going to. Like, we can just split up how we want to do whatever.
Okay, you wanted to go... Okay, I thought you wanted to go get the tooth checked out.
Appraised. Yeah, can it appraised. Probably down there, I imagine. Or no?
If you want to do that, the best place would probably be the Merchant's Guild.
Oh, well, okay.
But if you want to go to the Undercity, you can't.
I was thinking like the trinket shop might have been good, but
okay,
I don't know.
Okay. How do I do?
Would Valinor? I don't know. Sure. Good choice. This place is fucking gone.
There we go.
It's a burnt house.
Yes. So yeah, you see, the fire in the rolling cabbage has been put out. And in front of the doors, there is now two legionaries guarding the entrance.
Okay. So I don't know what you all are doing, but Valinor is going over to the trinket shop over here.
I'm going to go to the leather worker.
Oh, my disguise. Yeah, sorry. My disguise is gone. I'm back to my head, not my head bandana.
Oh, okay.
No, not bandana. The turban.
Yeah, okay. You can just... Yeah, that's fine.
Yeah.
So you want to go into Eurystheus' Knickknack Emporium?
Yeah, but other people can do stuff first if they want.
I'm staying in character. I'm going to continue to be the bodyguard.
Okay, you're guarding Valinor. Interesting.
That's not necessary, but okay.
It's my job, sir.
Is it because I gave you money? It's because I gave you money.
It's because I gave you money, sir.
Okay, so actually, before you go in there, you see a familiar face. He is leaning against this building, another drinking gourd in hand, just chugging it down.
Are you the same one?
He belches. Same one or what?
I punched next to his face, but not his face. I deliberately missed.
Okay, he kind of laughs. He's like, I see. You like punching random people, eh? So do I.
No. I mean, I know you do, but I was seeing if you were as quick as the other one. Are you the same one that was blacksmith?
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
It's me.
Hey, nice to see you again.
Fuma, the ninja, you know.
Oh, yeah.
Ninja?
Okay, Fuma.
Hey,
whatever you say, Fuma.
Blueberry, how's it going? And then he burps right again.
What did you just call me?
I called you a blueberry.
I'm gonna smack him in the face.
Okay, I'm gonna say roll for what would it be? Probably acrobatics. Yeah, just do a dex check, I guess.
Okay. 11. My dex is a plus 3. 14.
Okay, you miss quite clearly, and this guy is also standing on your head.
Oops. He's standing on my head?
He is standing on your head.
Roll a strength check.
Goddamn, I'm strong.
No, he's
seven strength.
He's very light on his feet.
that's not how that works. Okay.
He's just kind of like with his toes.
This man is like bloated with helium. He's actually 2 inches tall. Like,
what are you doing down there, blue guy?
That's better. You can call me blue guy. Don't call me blueberry.
All right.
Okay. Yeah, it's part of a fabled group of blue men.
People call me all sorts of things too, so I don't blame you.
What the hell is a ninja?
What do you mean, what's a ninja? It's a ninja.
Yeah,
you know?
What the hell is that?
Well, listen here, my friend, he grabs you by the shoulder, kind of takes you. You ever hear about the Koga?
Have I ever heard about the Koga?
Probably not.
No, I never heard of it.
Oh, well, that's a shame, my old buddy, my pal. Back in the day, we were all cool guys, you know, we're just chilling, having a good time, worshiping spirits.
Maxon.
What kind of spirits?
Yeah. What was it? The dragon spirit? Something like that? I don't know. I never was much into that kind of stuff. But, ever since the Keton got powerful in Tia, they didn't really like us very much, so in order to protect ourselves, we kind of got really good at killing shit without being seen, you know, my old friend.
That sounds useful.
Yeah, don't it? So, Mr. Blue Guy, what are you doing here?
Well, I'm actually here to kill shit without being seen.
Oh, I see.
Yeah.
I see. You want to be a ninja?
Yeah, do I have to worship dragons?
Oh, I sure don't.
Well, then sure.
Well, guess what, my old man, my buddy, my pal, you can't.
I can or I can't?
You can't, because who the hell's training you?
What the fuck did you bring it up for, then?
Oh, to fuck with you? Also, I'm pretty drunk.
Oh, yeah, okay. I don't like you.
Oh, that's no way to talk to your dear oldest friend.
Well, get off my head.
No, I did.
Oh, okay.
He's grabbing your shoulder. He's kind of nuzzling his head against your arm now.
All right, don't get comfortable.
No, we're buddies. We're pals, right? Right?
Yeah,
listen,
totally.
Listen. If you can be, you know.
I can be.
Maybe 6-7 years old and come to me, you know. If I'm not drunk, maybe I'll be your sensei.
Are you saying six or 7 years' time, or are you saying I have to be a child?
Yeah, you'd have to, you know, go back in time or some shit.
Are you saying I'm too old to train?
That was kind of what I was thinking.
And that I'd never reach the rank of master?
Yeah, exactly.
That's unfair.
You know, life can be unfair sometimes, you know. My stupid son, he goes and gets himself killed, right? I give him my sword, and he loses it and dies, and it's like, oh, I gotta go find the sword, and here I am, and now I'm drunk, and I don't have my sword or my son.
Was your son a ninja?
Yeah.
Did you train him?
Yeah.
Well, then I don't want you to train me, okay.
What? Why not?
What kind of
My son was an idiot. My training has nothing to do with that.
Okay. What kind of sword was it?
It was a Tionic Warblade, you know? The curved kind, the sharp ones.
Do I know?
It was called... Yeah, you know. Okay. Everyone knows.
Oh, that's true. I know weapons, so...
Yeah.
Okay.
It was called the Bakuen.
The Bakuen?
The Bakuen.
Oh, Bakuen.
Yeah. It was beautiful. The holy part was like all red, I think, and the blade shone like the sunrise. It was nice, and now I don't know where the hell it is, and like, it's a family thing, you know. I gotta find it somewhere.
Well,
I'm drunk.
Where's the last time you remember your son being?
Here. That's why I'm here.
Oh, he died in the city.
Somewhere, I think.
What is this guy, by the way? Is he just a human?
Yeah, he is. He's an Asian man.
He's an Asian human man.
Yeah.
Okay.
He is a Tianic human, I guess. He's a human from the Far East.
Okay. Well, I'll keep an eye out for a sunrise sword. Is that what you said?
Yeah. Sure.
Is that what he said? It looks like the sunrise.
He said its blade shone like the sunrise.
Okay. All right, I'll keep my eye out for that.
No, thanks, buddy.
What was your son doing here? And what was his name?
My son, his name was Fuga.
Wait, what was your name again?
Fuma.
Okay.
Here, come over here. Give me your hand, blue guy.
Yeah, sure.
My name's Fuma Choi Fawn. Pleased to meet you.
Choi Fawn. Yeah, my name is Kona.
Ah, Kona, that's a name. How do you spell that?
Double K O N A.
What was the first K? What was that for?
Yeah, well, if you need to know, you'll know.
As silent as he is.
Yeah.
Well, he's not very silent.
That's pretty good, though.
I'm drunk. I don't know who I'm talking to anymore.
I like that.
And then he burps again.
Yeah. Cover your mouth when you do that, okay? You're right next to me.
All right, Mom. Jesus.
Yeah.
All right, well, you know, I don't know if I have any rewards or anything, but here, you know what? Let me give you some advice, Mr. K Kona Blue. Blue Kona?
Yeah.
Blue Snow Cone?
Yeah. You got any more? Or are you
Snow
done?
Cone?
I think I'm done.
All right.
I think. For now.
Okay.
For now. You know what the most important thing in life? You know what that is, buddy? Old pal?
Probably depends on the person, but what is it?
It's your family. It's your family. You know, you gotta learn to who you love, who you wanna be.
That's a good point. Where's your wife?
Yeah. What the hell's a wife?
Well, where's the mother of your son?
Oh.
Oh, wow.
Dead,
okay.
Probably. I never met her.
Close knit family, I guess. Close knit family. You're really living up to his values.
What the hell's a wife?
This man gets me.
That's how I know. You know, that's how I know. You don't know what you got till it's gone.
Oh, okay.
Right?
Okay. Till you never dumb, had it.
Till your dumb fuck son goes and gets himself killed by a shadow or something.
Okay. Well, it was good talking to you. I'll keep an eye out for that sword, and thanks for no training.
No, I didn't say I wouldn't train.
I don't have a time machine, so.
What the fuck's a time machine?
You said I'd have to be 6.
Oh, how old are you?
Yeah. At least 7.
Well, that's probably fine. I don't. I could. I don't know. I don't think you want to be. I don't think you want to be trained. But if you do,
that's all my life has ever been.
Oh. Well, you know what? If you wanna be trained by me, if you wanna be trained by me, come back when you believe in the power of friendship.
Oh my god!
And then he just.
And that's his walk away line.
Yep.
What's that? Family, friendship, ninjas. What is happening?
Turn to
Valinor is very.
I'm gonna talk. I'm gonna look at Valinor like, was he real? Did that just happen? Or am I still drunk?
I don't know either, my dude.
He's asleep right in front of you.
Valinor is, or the guy?
No,
yes, I am.
No, much Choi Fong.
I rolled. I don't think he's real.
I don't think he's real.
I'm just gonna tooth. I enter the place.
Okay. I'm sorry. I needed to do that eventually.
It's fine. I gave you a bathroom break.
Okay, so you enter in the store. Inside is the bearded woman. And there's a wide variety of random crap of all sorts. Uh-huh. Anything useless that you could imagine there. And she comes up. She's like, "Oh, hello,
my friend. How can I help you?
Hello, beautiful.
I am Eurystheus, and this is my emporium.
Your emporium. Excuse me, I'm sorry. I have something in my possession that you may be interested in. Just browsing about your wares.
Yes.
I lay the yellow sawtooth on a flat surface. I don't know if she's behind the counter or not.
She is indeed.
I have this tooth from a giant dinosaur that we slayed out.
A dinosaur, you say? Have you been recently?
I have not listened to Helena by My Chemical Romance recently. Mookie, cut out, what'd you say?
You're missing out.
Have you been to the Hellades?
The Hellades?
The vast jungles of the Bilom Chilom.
Yes, that is actually where this is from.
Oh, yes. They say that's the only place where leviathans like this still live. Very fascinating.
It seems like it. I haven't seen them elsewhere.
It's very rare. You know, there are men in Shinar who like to eat crushed up leviathan bones because they think it will enlarge their genitalia.
Oh, well, it's a shame this is a tooth, not bone.
They don't know the difference.
That's fair. Well, if I could get it appraised, how much would you believe this is worth?
So she takes out a little manacle. She's inspecting it. She's like, very pure, very...
A manacle
very
is something that you use to charm.
Oh, is that?
Yeah, she has a monocle.
A monocle, that's sorry.
Or like a jeweler's, I mean. A jeweler's
yeah,
eye
the jeweler's monocle
thing.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay. And she's inspecting it.
I have...
Okay.
Very pure, yes. Beautiful. I will give you 100 gold solid eyes for such an exquisite prize.
Can I insight the check to see if she's trying to scam me or not?
Okay.
Alright. Teen stuff. Oh, 19 total.
You have a hankering that this item is worth at least 125.
Okay, how about... It seems this might be worth something like 130, just based on...
130, sir, that is highway robbery, I know, I could never.
Are you sure you could never? Because if you could sell it to make people's dicks bigger, they'll buy it for a lot of money.
Well, you know what, Mr. Handsome, if you give me a little kiss on the cheek, perhaps, you know, see what having me done.
Okay, so I will lean in, I'll put my hand on the beard cheek, and kiss it, and I'll cast light on her face as I do it.
It is a miracle, oh, handsome.
Oh, a miracle, wow.
Yes, here, please, take my money, oh, I'm so blessed.
All right, so 130?
Yes, 130.
Awesome.
Okay. Yeah, ka-ching!
Yeah.
And your pockets are now full of that gold.
Please, sir, come again anytime.
Oh, I promise you I shall. And I say not quietly as I walk out.
Yeah.
I pull beard hair
so,
out of my...
So as you nothing. Leave, you see Fuma, who is asleep. He's rolling. He's laying down and rolling in his sleep towards the Polyphemus's house. It's like a little rolling pin.
Badass. I like this man. Alright. Has he ever ended up inside the well?
He as he rolls, he hits the well, and he's stuck there now. He's just like,
oh. I'm gonna walk over and just kind of push him off to the side so he can keep on rolling.
rolling.
Yeah. Okay, I'm very sure that man does not exist. did you see him there too?
Yeah, that's impossible.
Yeah, that's not.
He literally rolled okay. He literally rolled onto the roof.
From the distance, you could just hear. I'm a ninja.
Does this man look a little bit like the fucking old grandpa from Dragon Ball Z?
My power comes from friendship.
Oh, yeah. He looks kind of like that, but fatter.
Yeah, yeah.
And he's wearing a straw hat.
Yeah, he's not like secretly ripped. Like he is, but it's under all the fat.
Yeah, exactly.
All right. Well, that is... It can be Bora's turn to do the Bora thing.
All right, Bora.
I'm going to go into the leather working shop.
Yeah, okay. So inside you see a completely normal looking boring man with a beard who's like, "Hello, welcome to my leather shop. How can I help you?"
"Hello, I'm looking to buy some leather armor."
Alright. What kind do you need?
I need, like typical leather armor, but like something with like some like rivets or studs in them, like studded, if that makes sense.
Oh, I see. Well, I mean, I think I'm quite the stud if, you know, I don't say so myself. So I would, you know, I have some studded leather. That would be 45 solid.
And I'm going to hand him the solid.
All right.
Jesus.
He hands you the armor. He's like, thanks for doing business, filthy mutant.
Wait, hold on. And then I'm going to, like, inspect the back. Is there, like, enough room for me to, like, fit my giant fuck-off third leg through?
Yes, there is.
Okay, that is good. I say, never mind, it's fine. So I'm going to hand him the 45 solid die.
Okay.
He's got a giant fuck-off third leg. Wink.
I can use it for lots of.
Yeah.
I kind of figured.
Okay. So there you go. You are now a studded leather person.
Okay.
I'm going to catch up with these guys.
Okay.
Well, I'm.
What do you think of my new armor?
Looks dope.
It looks good. Do you know what ninjas are?
Oh, that guy I tried to punch. He said he was a ninja.
Yeah, Sam's sleeping on the.
Was it the same guy?
Are you drunk too?
Oops.
Are you drunk, Aurora?
No, not anymore.
We should. I need to fix that.
I didn't think I was either, but I think we might still be drunk.
There was.
Yeah. Oh my god.
That man is a mystery among. Cryptids. Cryptid of cryptids.
Oh my god, where was. I know I had an actual picture for him somewhere.
Please don't.
I love this man.
I think it was in the last one.
Yeah.
There you go. But I think that's about all of Valinor. What do you.
Yeah, there
it is. I don't know, wouldn't you want to. If other people have stuff, I'm just gonna sit back, basically.
Alright.
I'm just waiting for this tournament, dude.
Oh, do you guys want to go scout out the Colosseum?
Not really.
Yeah, you might be able to see really. Some of the people we will fight.
Oh,
true.
Oh, that is a good. Okay, interesting.
Like, maybe they're like doing push-ups or something.
Plus, we can get the paperwork
like,
out of the way.
Sweaty, and they're just like grappling each other in loincloths.
Yep.
Well,
wait, what were we doing?
You have taken the ferry to the Colosseum. Because it's like, oh, what did you guys do?
Easy, yeah.
There you go. Oh, also, Gallus is not here.
So
you see, you were in a large public square. What time is it? Okay. Going till 2. There is a large public square here. People are kind of walking around. You can see on one side of you is a massive hippodrome, but not too many people are in there. And then on the other side is this huge Colosseum, and people are like coming and going.
Guys, I think that's the Colosseum over there.
Excellent observation.
Was that Back to the Future music?
I don't know. It sounds like it.
Well, it was for a second. It's
no, it
anymore.
Is Zelda music. It's Zelda music.
It's just a da-na-na-na-na.
Yeah. I definitely heard it. Where is my models? I know I had a guy.
Who fucking picked Zelda, dude? Thanks for getting me copy striked.
Is this the guy? Yes, he is.
It's Fuga.
No, that's not Fuga. Fuga's dead.
No, I know. He's just red like Fuma.
Yeah.
Fuga's allegedly dead.
Yeah, allegedly. You don't know that for sure. Yeah, I'll change this guy's color. To, I don't know, gray. Okay, so you see in the courtyard, I'll I don't know. You see things I haven't prepared for you guys to see yet, so fuck.
I don't see
God
anything.
Damn it, Kit. Yeah, I know you don't.
Wait, I thought you said
problem.
We see things.
Yeah, you kind of see what you see.
Yeah, the Colosseum and the guards.
Yeah.
Oh, I thought you said we see things we're not supposed to see yet.
No, I see things that I haven't prepared yet.
Oh, okay.
Is there any sort of like colorful characters?
You don't have to
around?
Show us on the thing. We can just RP this in our minds.
Yeah. Yeah, you can RP this in your minds.
Yeah, so we're walking towards the Colosseum.
Okay. Walking towards the Colosseum. There's like a line of people. They're exiting.
Excuse me, actual fighters coming through.
And they're just like, oh, and they're kind of like looking at you in shock. And, you know, some people, they're munching on popcorn and stuff as they leave.
I flex a little bit. Just to tighten up my body a little bit.
As you flex,
I slap my forehead.
He's like, ooh.
I slap Aurora's forehead.
Thank you.
So
you're welcome.
Okay, so you come to this big counter area where there's a man. It's like, I'm sorry, sir, but the fight's just ended. How can I? If you want to see something, you're gonna have to come back tomorrow.
Oh, we're fighters in the tournament tomorrow.
Oh, you're fighters.
Yeah.
Did you register?
Do we need to do that, or does our like team owner need to do that?
Well, in theory, anyone. I mean, if he's your manager, he probably should. But
I don't know if he did.
Do you have his name on here?
We are registered under Rashidun Al Kawaraz.
Kawarazan.
Oh, I see. Are you one Mr. Ashad Al Kamal?
Yeah.
Nope. We're the replacements.
What did he go missing too?
Yeah.
It's happened a lot recently. A lot of our, most of the people fighting in here are, slaves, right? It's typical gladiator slaves. But tomorrow being the holiday and all, tournament's open to everybody. Kind of a festivities thing. So we're kind of swamped at the moment. But here, he hands you a large scroll. If you sign your life away here, sir, we will show up here tomorrow morning. Well, we will get you accommodated.
Wait, why did you phrase
sure
it like that?
Phrase it like what?
Sign your life away.
Well, sir, the city of Amalthine cannot be held responsible if you happen to die.
Oh,
in this
okay,
arena.
Okay. I thought you remember just.
It did sound like you were enslaved.
Yeah, that's what it sounded like.
Oh, well. If you want to be enslaved, you can head down to our local gladiator's office and become a permanent slave. If you
hear
will.
That, Aurora?
Usually we take criminals, but, you know.
I'm playing with
Do
flowers.
I look like a criminal to you?
I'm sorry, sir, but yes, kind of.
Wow.
Yeah, it's very judgy. Okay. It's very judgy of you.
Well,
is this guy
know,
human?
This guy is a human, and he has a thick 70s porn star mustache.
Yeah. Ooh. Awful.
Okay. He looks kind of like Ned Flanders.
Wait, what's this man's name? Did he give us one?
No, he didn't give you a name.
I'm gonna name him Reese.
Reese.
I'm gonna yank that thing off. Okay.
Oh, I have a question for the fight.
Yes, ma'am.
Will we be fighting each other, or will we be fighting, like, giant monsters and stuff? Or can you not tell us?
Oh, no. Technically, I have to tell you, you will be fighting other teams.
Oh, good.
Some of these teams may or may not include giant monsters.
To the death?
Do I have to not kill them? Like, do I have to make sure that they are alive?
No. Have you never been to a Colosseum, small mutant girl?
I'm not a mutant. I'm just a nation.
Yes, a mutant, exactly.
You're a mutant.
What? He is taken aback. He's like, what?
What? Just galaxy brain explosion thing.
Yeah.
From my point of view, the Jedi are you.
then you are lost.
Wowie zowie.
Speaking of which, does KC exist?
Yeah, he exists. In some capacity.
He snuck back into what's-his-name's room.
Yeah, he's back in your headless room.
I'm not saying I want to kill people, but, like, if I accidentally happen to, like, kill someone or hit them hard enough so that they'd stop moving.
Oh, yeah. That's
like,
fine.
Like, in trouble.
Usually, no, of course not. Usually it's up to you. Generally, the crowd, you know, the crowd will kind of give you what they want. You know, sometimes they'll ask for mercy if they thought they put up a good fight. But, you know, other times they'll want the opponent to, then he does the finger across the throat motion, like, yeah, so, you know. So, yeah.
They want them to make them a necklace?
No, ma'am. Sometimes the crowd would prefer it if you.
I get it.
You know,
people slice the throat and the blood comes out.
Yeah, you know, people like the blood. But you know, if you want to be a good heel, you give the crowd exactly what they don't want, and then everyone hates you. So then it's time when you know you're on the losing end. They'll cheer for you to die. It's kind of you know you got to put up a good show anyway.
Well, the trick is to never lose.
Yeah, exactly. So after you say that, Aurora, a man walks up behind you and he's like, "Oh, yes, that is exactly what the trick is. I like the way you think, small horned girl."
I like then jump back and like turn around like, "What is that?"
What the fuck is that?
The guy at the counter, he's like, "Oh no, not this guy again." He's like, "Yes, it is I, Hamby Oryx, the great hurricane of Gallia, come here to win fame and fortune. Hello, my strange companions. I look forward to seeing you tomorrow on the field of battle."
What are you saying?
What do you mean? What am I saying? I am a proud...
No, you're not Zemian.
God bless you.
Yeah, oui, thank you.
I'm sorry, but I don't have any extra gold to give to you.
No, I do not want your gold. I only want to cross swords.
I only have my credit
mighty,
card on me right now. Sorry.
At the mighty open field, you know what I am saying.
Okay. I understand what they're saying. I'm sorry, I'm not a prostitute.
Oh, No.
Yes.
Oh, cross and sword.
Madame, I am a very noble chest knight. I do not partake in the prostitutes.
I love
officially. Oh. Then he gives you a wink, like.
You can't just ask people to show them your chest.
I am sorry, miss.
There's not even very much there for me.
Your horned woman, I do not know what of she speaks.
I know you're horny, but you can't just ask people to see their chest.
Is she a little banged up in the head, monsieur?
I'm not going to bang you. And do what with your what?
I am quite confused by this predicament, but I just wanted
don't
to
understand what he is saying.
To talk about how excited I am for tomorrow, but...
Okay, listen to his ridiculous accent.
Keep it in your pants, guy. Come on.
Do you not
Who are you?
I guess this is what I get when you come to Bina. All these filthy foreigners.
We're fighting you tomorrow? Is that what you're trying to say? Whatever the words you're saying?
Oui, okay. oui, monsieur.
Okay. You fighting to the death?
To the death, I fight for the romance of the field of battle, for the duel and the honor of a great knight of Avalonia.
But do you fight to the death?
Well, then
make sure you say goodbye to anyone you say goodbye to.
Oh, I am regretting. I was trying to make friends with.
We can be friends. Yeah, we'll be friends.
Oh, hey, monsieur. And then he goes up to you and he tries to kiss you on the cheek, as is customary in his land.
Just one cheek or both cheeks?
Oh, both cheeks.
He could kiss one cheek. That's it.
Okay. Oh, monsieur, I apologize. See, we're. Friendship is not at that stage yet. Yes, not yet. All right, monsieur. Well, if you need anything from the other combatants, come to the Ludus Amala, the greatest gladiator school in all.
In all what?
Amosin.
Oh, okay.
Monsieur, monsieur. Yes, yes, I have come here. I have come here in search of fame and fortune and adventure. Yes.
Cool, cool.
Yes, yes, monsieur. Anyway.
Have you killed a lot of slaves?
Have I killed a lot of slaves?
Yeah. For, you know, your honorable pursuit?
Yes, yes, of course, sir.
I see, okay.
Yes.
Thanks for being honest.
Of course, monsieur. I will look forward to crossing my blade with yours.
Me too.
And then he flexes his arms with his big, manly physique as he walks past.
I'm going to go up to Conan and I'm going to whisper in his ear, I didn't know you were a prostitute.
Hey, you gotta make a living somehow. I literally didn't have any money until Valinor gave me some.
Oh, do you want some money?
I'm not gonna say no.
I'm going to give you 20 salt blood dye.
Holy shit.
Wow.
What's that? I can't even imagine the percentage I just increased my money to.
How does Aurora have so much money?
Yeah, how the fuck does anybody say?
Oh, I see.
I had 5 Aurelius. That's the max I had this fucking campaign. So, and I gave it away to somebody who needed it.
I think I've had nearly 200 now.
Where the fuck did you get this money from?
Obviously, you're not doing a good job of stealing people's money. Yeah. For a thief.
I'm looting bodies, but all I found was like 2 bullets maybe each time.
What about those swords? Did we end up selling those?
I think you guys
did that part.
They're not sold. They're sitting there waiting to be used as scrap for your armor.
Yeah, yeah. You gave them to Polyphemus so he could melt them down and make you a suit of armor after you find his...
What was that guy's name again? Heverix the Hurricane?
Ambiorix the Hurricane.
Oh, Ambiorix. Holy shit. Ambiorix. Double H, yeah.
Yeah, I wrote his name on him, his model, if you click on it.
Oh, okay. That works.
I tried to do that to everybody.
Yeah, I just don't try to spoil it.
Was this like a horse racing part?
It was going to be until I decided that it would be much easier to do it in a Colosseum instead of the Hippodrome. That's why I have both of them here.
And he said to check out the Ludus Amala for gladiator training?
Yeah, that's where gladiators, they hang out.
Weren't we talking to a guy, though, about signing up shit?
Yeah, he's right in front of you.
Did we do that, or no? Did we just take the paper?
He gave you the paper. I don't know if you signed it or not.
Oh, yes.
Yeah, I guess we all sign it.
No, I said yes.
And I'm going to forge a Gallus' signature.
Okay. Is that a thing you can do?
Well, I have a forgery kit.
All right, perfect.
And I've spied in her journal before.
Okay, so you're going to draw a little heart above the eye.
Yeah, exactly.
There we go. You know how it's done.
Oh, Conan, I just remembered something that we could... there's a set of paperwork that could be helpful for this, you know, quote-unquote transaction for later. And I think we could forge some sort of bill of sale. If I give you an example, could you make something similar?
I could definitely try.
Okay. And I'm going to... hand him this note.
And we're doing that today, correct?
Yes, you're doing that basically today, aka next week, aka whenever
or
Kat
tomorrow,
is
whatever we decide on.
Yeah, whenever I can amass the gamers.
Okay.
It's like 7 in the morning right now. Or something.
It's early.
Yeah, it is probably around 8 o'clock right now.
Bombs away.
Bombs away.
I hear Tracer. KB Overwatch. Has abandoned us for Overwatch.
Did he really?
No.
Casey's lighting up her lucky. Someone said bombs away.
Casey is in
bombs
a custom game.
Away.
What the fuck?
That's what I call multitasking. Good gaming, Casey. I appreciate that.
Casey hasn't been existing here.
Yeah,
we haven't heard from him like 40 minutes.
He went to buy arrows and he never came back.
Yeah. No, Rizzy, he got distracted.
He
went
to buy cigarettes.
He got distracted by a game of stickball that some children were playing in front of the store. So that's just kind of what he's off doing.
I don't trust Rizzy with children playing stickball.
He's just kicking around the ball.
Bad Rizzy.
Is there, am I changing anything on this,
Well, we should probably change the name of, the seller to Commodus whatever.
Commodus.
Commodus
who? Commodus whatever.
Commodus, what was your last name?
Adile
was his job.
Adile is his job. I guess you could say Adile Commodus.
And he's selling you to the senator guy?
For...
That's what we're faking.
Yeah, I mean, gifting.
Oh,
right.
Yeah. Cool. Age of Property 6.
That is... This is a
pretty old
bill of sale.
Oh, this is just one you had on you?
This is... Yeah. This is one that was mine years ago.
Oh, okay.
And say probably to the order
that's
of
that's unfortunate.
Nothing.
Okay. Well, I have the potential thing, but I probably have to, I'm assuming, go back to our room or something and do this. Forge it so it's nice and neat.
You can,
or do I just need to put the paper on somebody's back?
I'm going to say you can do it wherever you find a flat surface.
Okay.
Use my chest.
don't sell yourself short.
Yeah. Oh my God. Flat, not short. I mean, short too, but yeah, whatever.
But I am 22.
Well, maybe there'll be a flat surface at the Ludus Amala.
Yes.
But anyway, we all sign that thing, I guess. While,
yep.
While Rizzy and Domri go on the roof of that building over there.
Yeah, well, mm-hmm. I mean, they're here in spirit. You look over and you see their faces in the clouds, because really, Domri's hanging out with those nerds back at the temple.
Oh, okay.
And, mm-hmm. and Rizzy's playing a ball with the kids.
Yeah.
Okay. Cool.
So you're just going to have to, I guess, forge their names, too.
Yeah, I'll forge their names.
That's fine.
I'm gonna make Rizzy's look like a child wrote it though.
Yeah.
Just shitty handwriting.
Enough. Yeah.
Children love me. Oh no. Yeah. You do have bunny ears.
Yeah, exactly. They're like, oh, Mr. Fluffy Bunny.
Oh god, they start pulling on him.
Yeah.
You know, I'm over here looking like a fucking demon.
I'm sorry.
Oh
demons
my god.
Are
cuter. I have a picture for you.
Good. What?
In Discord.
Have you ever seen a naked...
No, I haven't.
What? What is even that?
That's Alberta for ya.
Texas.
Yeah, it is. Anyway. Anyway, okay. So do you guys still want to do anything, or do you guys want to freeze time?
We should probably freeze time, seeing as I think Cad has deceased.
Yeah.
All right. R.I.P.
We can reconvene.
Yeah.
Okay. So what I'm gonna do is I'm just gonna say
I catch up to the boys before we.
Ooh. Okay.
We start walking faster. We start walking faster.
Let's just do the
fast
thing.
Dog.
You pretend that you don't.
We should all be T-posing around Agalis when she comes to.
Oh my god.
And then we just start doing the Halo theme, whatever Halo is.
I'm actually salty that Kat it wasn't here, because I had something really cool planned for what was gonna happen to him.
It's not so
like thank god, like, I had a way for him to just not be in the game, because I mean he was gonna be like in kind of a magical coma thing anyway, so it's just extended now.
Okay. Coma wife.
Yeah, that's Kat. He's a
insert boomer joke here.
Whoa. Who was... That was Groovy.
That was Groovy.
Oh. I was like, someone's already just like, bye.
Yeah. Later, fuckers.
I don't need a wrap up.
Alright. Yeah. I have closed the game, by the way. So.
Okay, so bye.
Oh, shit. Then I guess I'll
stop
recording.
Yeah.